As the temperature heats up and the days become longer, that can only mean one thing. The biggest party of the summer is here once again. It's time for SummerSlam. The annual Summer Spectacular has been host to some of the greatest moments in WWE history.
Look at Andre, he's bewildered.
John Stewart, what have you done? Hulkamania could end tonight.
What has become the most anticipated event of the summer started over 30 years ago at the world's most famous arena, Madison Square Garden. On that evening, the self-proclaimed greatest intercontinental champion of all time, the Honky Tonk Man, walked in exuding confidence, having held the title well over 400 days. Little did he know he would be in for the ultimate challenge.
This contest is for the Intercontinental Championship, and it is scheduled for one fall. Approaching the ring, led by his manager, Colonel Jimmy Hart, from Memphis, Tennessee, weighing 248 pounds, here is the Intercontinental Champion, the
Big smile on the face of the Honky Tonk Man. He doesn't even know who his opponent is.
That's right, brother, but he's always confident. You know, he may be one of the greatest Intercontinental Champions. I tell you, the guy's had that title over 2 years now, Gorilla Monsoon. And you know, the man has fought some top people all the way along the line. I mean, he's confident, brother. I've never seen a man without confidence.
Well, it goes without saying. He's got the Colonel, the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart. I, for one, am certainly anxious to find out who, in fact, is the number one challenger now that Brutus the Barber Beefcake has been shelved temporarily.
No question about it, but it doesn't look like the Honky Tonk
Man. Nobody sent any word up to us.
Nothing to us, brother. The Honky Tonk Man doesn't care.
His opponent.
He don't even want to know.
Here it comes. Who is his opponent? Come on, Howard. Howard doesn't even know.
Howard Finkel, the announcer, doesn't know. Come on, brother. Let's get
he
it
shook
together.
Shook his head.
Get me somebody out here to wrestle. I don't care who it is.
Oh,
don't say he that, don't care.
Don't say that, my man. There's some people back there in the locker room who would take this man apart.
We're all waiting here with anticipation as to who the opponent will be. Well, maybe we haven't got an opponent.
Well, maybe we have an opponent, but, you know, maybe he's still lacing up his boots. Who knows, man?
Wait a minute. Somebody's music.
That's familiar music, brother.
They've exploded here in the garden. I don't see anybody yet.
Here is the Summer Slam.
It's the Ultimate Warrior.
One man. Oh, look at him attack.
This place has gone bananas.
Ultimate Warrior, Lord. I mean, the Gorilla Monsoon. They're going to take over, man. That's what you do when you want something. You go out and get it, baby.
Ultimate Warrior exploding here on the Honky Tonk Man. Beautiful fly tackle. The bell is gone, and it's officially underway.
The Warrior doesn't know what to do. He's so excited.
The title definitely up for grabs here.
Oh, we could get a new champion right now, Gorilla Monsoon. Right now, brother, we could get a new champion. I'm here to
Big
tell you.
Big Splash hooks the leg.
That's
he
it.
Got it. History has been made here.
Oh, goodness. I love it. I love it.
Look at this place go bananas.
Pandemonium has run wild in Madison Square Garden, my man.
History once again made here, Madison Square Garden.
The winner of this contest and new Intercontinental Champion, the Ultimate Warrior.
It had to be record time, Gorilla Monsoon. It had to be record time, brother.
It is unbelievable. The Garden has gone strictly bananas. History made as part of SummerSlam 88. A newly crowned Intercontinental Champion.
He went out.
The Ultimate Warrior. Oh, look at him.
Yeah, he went out and crowned himself.
Yeah.
with the Ultimate Warrior tearing the roof off MSG with his Intercontinental Championship victory, SummerSlam was immediately solidified as the hottest event of the summer. So hot, in fact, that in 1992, WWE staged its own British invasion as SummerSlam took over Wembley Stadium, with over 80,000 rabid fans witnessing the culmination of months of family turmoil between not only two WWE legends, but brothers-in-law.
The families don't seem to know which side to take, your side or my side.
It was a family affair, as the excellence of execution, Bret the Hitman Hart, put his Intercontinental Championship on the line against his own brother-in-law, England's favorite son, the British Bulldog.
Oh, look at the spectacle, yes, of SummerSlam!
Here we go. And a bit of a stare down here. Psychological. Whoa. They're psyching each other out, that's what they're doing.
This matchup tearing the respective families apart.
Oh, I'm sick and tired of hearing about families being torn apart.
Really?
Yeah, that's what it's all about, winning the belt and getting all that money. Who cares about your family? They don't do nothing for you except come to your house at Thanksgiving, try to mooch a meal.
What a humanitarian, Bobby the Brain Heenan.
I'm the king of England.
Yeah, all right, you're the king, all right. And look at that, everybody, Hitman Bret Hart. Whoa,
how about that?
Whoa, all the way to the outside.
Look at the determination in his face. I think he knows he's got it. I don't know why he lets Whoopi Goldberg do his hair.
What? The Hitman, back up. Back into the ring. A lesser man would have already been counted out after that. Once again, locking up.
Oh,
nice takedown by the Hitman. Head scissor, kick out. Oh, look at this. And again, no missing with that. So the Hitman, Bret Hart, taking the British Bulldog over.
A very evenly matched, if you think about it. Neither of them are too bright.
What do you mean by that? Oh, my! Over the British Bulldog! One! Oh, 2 minutes in!
Go! Whoa!
Small package one! We get to it! And a nice takeover again by the Hitman, Bret Hart.
And he took him over from his knees. He had all the moves, all the speed, the agility, and the leverage. That's why they call him the excellence of execution. I think he might be getting executed tonight.
Really?
Yep.
Obviously, the Hitman Bret Hart must contend with the power of the British Bulldog. And again, as you mentioned, the British Bulldog must contend with the technical skills of Bret Hart. Oh, nice escape. And then a hammerlock, climbing the knee down. And again. Oh, what an elbow right in the kisser.
Hit him right in the old fish and chips.
Bret Hart now in control. Much like the matchup between the Ultimate Warrior and the Macho Man, Randy Savage. Wow. Expect this to be a seesaw, grueling type battle. Davey Boy, look at this. Trying to make the move. Oh, what an escape, what a reversal. What a takedown that was by the British Bulldog.
And really, if you think about it, good wrestling. He didn't try to do anything cute or fancy. He took him, who's that, Mike McGurk?
And Diana looking on with great consternation.
Not looking like to me. But right down, took him down with that hold and stayed on it.
Both men back to their feet. Bret Hart now trying to escape, doesn't he? Goes downstairs. Davey Boy coming off the rope. Oh, yes! And
for the run. Oh, did he hit that corner? He looks confident, I'm telling you. He looks confident. Well, he's got 80,000 of his neighbors in his backyard right here.
Perhaps the dream of the British Bulldog will come true. Oh, way up. Oh, wow. Bret Hart back to his feet. One of the truly great competitors in the WWF, the Hitman Bret Hart. Off the look. No, God, it's going to be a new champ. No.
Back to basics. Took him back down with the hole that got him there. Listen to these people. Can you hear me? Or are you just ignoring me? What do you mean, yes?
The British Bulldog applying more pressure to the shoulder area. A very concerned Diana looking on. Her greatest wish is that neither individual is hurt as a result of the matchup. Oh, slammed by the Hitman Bret Hart, but actually applied even more pressure on the hold. Possessed by Davey Boy as a result of that.
He's bending the wrist backwards now. You know, you can't beat a man if you can't grab the man. And if you're working a man's wrists and arms long enough, he's going to lose all strength in his hands. I know these things.
Yeah, sure you know.
A broadcast journalist.
And also the king.
The king of England. Boy, will Davey Boy Smith be sucking up to me if he wins that title.
Oh, will he now? Davey Boy Smith for the run. Bret Hart goes downstairs, back up. Oh, yes! Nice maneuver by the Hitman. And right now, the pound is not the only English thing that's taking the beating. No, it's the British Bulldog.
You mean the pound where he lives?
I beg your pardon?
The pound where
not the dog pound, that's the pound I'm talking about.
Make yourself clear. I'm in a foreign country. Nobody here speaks English.
I thought you were the King of England.
I am the King of England. Still a foreign country. I'm moving the castle over to Beverly Hills.
Nobody's now. The Hitman Bret Hart. Would you stop it?
What? Stop what?
Bret Hart. Content to grind it out now in the British Bulldog as Davey Boy Smith makes his move. Elbows in the midsection. Another one driving in the midsection. Shoulder blocker, how about that? The Hitman Bret Hart saw it coming.
Look,
took a step with him and nailed him with the elbow. Yeah.
They're taking their time. They know what they're doing. Nobody's rushing anything. They know they're going to be here for a while, and they know what's at stake.
And oh my, reverse pile driver, yes! The Hitman Bret Hart pouring it on. Davey Boy Smith now whipped to the ropes again. This time, here we go! No! How about that?
He's trying to try.
Yes! What a maneuver by the Hitman Bret Hart! That could be it! No! Count it two! Wow, what a matchup!
Davey Boy's got to beat him. Bret Hart does not have to beat Davey Boy. He can hold him in that hole for the next 60 minutes and walk away still Intercontinental Champion.
And again, we must reinforce the fact that it'll take a pin or a submission to win a championship in the WWF.
And I can't see the British Bulldog with 80,000 of his neighbors here quitting.
Stranger things that have happened, Bobby Heenan in the World Wrestling Federation.
And I can't see Bret Hart quitting and giving up the title.
And to the rope, coming up. On goes the British Bulldog. Bret Hart, right back at him. Leap back by the British Bulldog, trying to hook it. Yes, nice maneuver. The British Bulldog with things swinging back his headbutt. The Hitman for the ride to the buckle. Oh, my.
the first time he's ever used his head.
And again, here comes, forget about it. The Hitman Bret Hart almost took the British Bulldog's head right out. And now this capacity crowd of 80,355 beginning to show their partisanship. Down goes, oh no.
Oh yeah, the Bulldog just got bulldogged.
The Hitman Bret Hart on the outside on the apron. Oh, wait a minute, look, he's going up, all the way up.
He's in trouble now.
On the top, no, the British Bulldog catches him. Bret Hart for the rock.
And now Benny Boy Smith goes to the outside. The British Bulldog's gonna try it himself all the
this
way
to the top rope. Bret Hart,
no.
Look at that. You know, Bret Hart playing possum.
That's funny, Bret Hart was not moving. He was motionless. Then all of a sudden, boom. He is setting the Bulldog up for exactly what he wants him to do, make mistakes.
The Hitman Bret Hart, the wily veteran.
And again, we hear a response from this somewhat partisan crowd. Behind now, Davey Boy Smith. Shoving, no, look at this, right out. My goodness, right in front of us. A clever maneuver on the part of the Hitman, Bret Hart.
However, he is being booed. What are these limeys booing for?
Stop
it. It was a good move.
It was an excellent move nonetheless.
And it was legal.
I believe that this capacity crowd is so caught up in the pageantry, so caught up in the excitement of SummerSlam, they just can't help but root for the British Bulldog. He's one of their own here in London, England. And what a golden opportunity for the British Bulldog to become Intercontinental Champion.
One of their own, huh?
Oh, my goodness.
Did you see that?
I've never seen that before, ever.
He about broke his neck.
He may have.
Oh, you're going to have to take the hound home, honey.
Unfortunately, this is turning perhaps into a nightmare for Diana. Oh, no, look at that.
How bad does he want to hold on to that belt? He doesn't care if the Smith family likes him. He wants to retain his title.
And the British Bulldog shoved back into the ring. The Hitman Bret Hart with all the momentum in the world.
You know, I thought the Bulldog had it from the beginning because he showed that confidence. But he is hurt. He is definitely hurt.
Davey Boy Smith whipped to the ball. Was he ever?
Plus, he's British. That makes him a quitter.
What?
Well, don't you know that?
The respective families of both individuals looking on with great interest. Beck Becker.
Davey Boy.
Stellar kick out by the British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith.
But he barely got out of that one.
What an forearm uppercut. And I can't believe Davey Boy is still on his feet. Look at this. My goodness.
I'll tell you, if Lennox Lewis throws a punch like that, he'll win his fights.
Drop kick by the Hitman.
Seems to me the Hitman smells it. He can taste it. He knows he's got him where he wants him right now. He is going to put him away in front of all his neighbors.
And Lennox Lewis, as you mentioned earlier, will attempt to put Razor Ramon away here in London as well. Oh, my! Oh, no!
Razor Ramon is fighting.
Razor Ramon. Here's a cover, one, two, and no! Indeed, just as the Hitman Bret Hart and the British Bulldog have a date with destiny here tonight at SummerSlam, Lennox Lewis will square off against Razor Ramon on October 31.
Halloween.
The Hitman Bret Hart now in total control of the matchup.
He's been in total control for a long time.
And here we go for the rock.
It'll be a short suplex, I bet.
Yes!
That one takes a lot out of
him. One, two, go.
There's still a little fight left in that old hound, isn't there?
An old hound.
Oh, isn't that good looking guy? They should put his face on a stamp. Or you should stomp on his face, one or the other.
David Lloyd Smith has been top dog for some time.
Oh, wow. Yeah, you can see the fleas jumping off him from here.
Oh, my. Oh, look at that. One of another two, and yes, and oh, so close. I thought that was it for sure. Again, Diana looking on with great interest. But her interest in this matchup different than the 80-some-odd thousand. Oh, my.
Sure, she'd rather her husband wins. I know it.
You don't know anything.
Well, she's not going to mooch money off the family like she does her husband.
Hitman Bret Hart down with the elbow. And that could do it. That could do it. Bret Hart still the Intercontinental.
I'm telling you, that mutt's got a little fight left in him yet.
Hard right hand to the back of the head.
Look at that.
A yank of the hair.
Oh, he won't do that to Bret Hart. There's too much grease in his hair for him to hold on.
And again, the partisan crowd a moment ago booing the hitman Bret Hart. The snap once again in complete control, and now Bret Hart begins to dominate the tempo of this matchup.
That's right, and he's leaning on him right now. He's cutting off his air. Look the way he's got the ball. You can't breathe good bent over when a guy's choking off your air. Yep, tea time is over. You can put away the crumpets, put away the lemon,
and that's it. That'll do it.
Night, night, sweetheart.
The Hitman Bret Hart with a sleeper hold, and British Bulldog Davey Boy Smith reaching for the rope way too far away. What a matchup this has been nonetheless.
He's down to both knees now.
Give the British Bulldog credit. This has been a tremendous effort on his part to become Intercontinental Champion. Oh, wait a minute.
Look at that dog.
He's got it. He's got it. He hooked the rope. He hooked the rope. Wait a minute. Let him go. The Hitman Bret Hart, he better let that hole go. He's going to cause some permanent damage.
To what?
Bret Hart almost risking his qualification.
To who? The Bulldog? Yeah, like you're going to really mess up his mind, huh?
Brother against brother-in-law.
Well, they're brother-in-law.
As far as Diana's concerned, look at this. Oh, my! Again, back into the sleeper hole.
I think he's choking him. Well, it doesn't matter.
Well, this family feud is just about over.
It's like a civil war.
It's been an uncivil war.
Oh, excuse me.
The British Bulldog is out, but yet it seems as though he won't give up.
Come on, referee, raise his hand and check. Oh, no, that puppy's out. He knows he's got him now. Night, night, Limey. It's all over. Bring me another order, tea and crumpets. I got some fight left.
Back to the corner, the hole broken. But right back with it again.
He's got it again.
Hitman Bret Hart, very smart to go right back to the same hole.
This is it. This is it. He went down. He didn't stay on his feet too long. Fourth way, he's getting up now.
Where in the world is he getting the strength from?
Oh.
That, however, took something out of the Hitman. The back of his head snapping back into the buckle. Oh, a slugfest.
Brother-in-law's just punching it out. I like it.
To the rope and up. Oh, up and no. Oh, no. Look at that.
Shish kebab, anyone? looks like
Bret Hart taking a bad fall. Oh, and a clothesline by the British Bulldog. Now momentum shifting back on Crosby the other way. And another one. The cover. One, two, no.
Barely, though. Barely did he get out of there.
Unbelievable strength possessed by the cover again. Two and two and a half again.
What a match. I don't care who wins, but what a match.
Well, we certainly found out there's no quitting the British Bulldog, and we're finding out the very same thing here with the Hitman Bret Hart, who's about ready to go up. Yes, way up.
Four, five, six, seven, eight.
Whoa, what a suplex.
Almost 10 seconds. Man.
We're the new champion, yes.
Yeah. Oh, no.
No, no.
Every eye here is focused right in the middle of that ring.
Bret Hart whipped to the back.
Oh, no. That'll do it for sure.
No one survives to it.
That's just about took his head off.
Can you believe this? The British Bulldog has to be getting frustrated by now.
What's he going for now? He's wasting too much time. You want it, dummy. You better go get it. You're wasting time.
He was signifying he's going to go for the power slam. Could very well be the way. The British Bulldog wins the Intercontinental Championship. If in fact he does.
There's the dog taking another mutt for a walk.
Here we go. And down. Yes. One, two. Yeah, no.
I don't know anymore. I can't believe it. Look at Davey Boy. Look at Davey Boy. He can't believe it.
I don't believe anyone's ever kicked out of that. What else does the British Bulldog have to do to Bret Hart to win the championship?
That's the turning point. When he couldn't beat him with his own finishing maneuver, and as stymied as he is, that's where he lost it right there. He can't beat Bret Hart. He can't beat the Hitman.
You may have a point there.
Of course I have a point there. And the King of England. Moron.
Davey Boy, no, from behind the Hitman Bret Hart. Suplex, it's over, two, yes.
Oh, are you kidding me? Only one man I know that can get up from all these moves. That's Ric Flair.
Oh, please.
Is there anything they haven't done?
I don't believe so. Bret Hart hooking, no, Davey Boy blocks the attempt at a suplex and blocks it again. The Hitman Bret Hart, whoa, goes up to the top rope.
Bret is
Bret
hurt.
Hart almost went sail.
Oh, the top,
no.
The top.
Oh, no.
He's
oh,
going to
no.
suplex him from the top rope.
Tell me this. From the top rope.
He's
down. Good.
A new champion.
Two. Can't believe it.
Wow.
I think we've seen just about every wrestling move there is to see thus far in this seesaw matchup.
What a match.
Off the rope. And again.
Oh.
Double clothesline. Both men out.
What a match, huh, McMahon?
Unbelievable, what a night! What a SummerSlam!
Uh-oh, he's going for the sharpshooter.
Yes!
He's gonna set him up in the sharpshooter.
Bret Hart having presence of mind.
Flat on his back, half unconscious, knows enough to do this. He can't turn him. He can't, he can turn him.
There he goes!
I knew he could turn him.
What?
He's got the hind legs of that mutt.
Oh, yes, the sharpshooter upon. It's all over.
Nobody's ever gotten out of this. Give it up. Give it up. Give it up. You can have some tea. Take the easy way out, pal. Give it up. Your wife
imagine
will drive
the
home.
Pain the
British Bulldog is in. Yes, and yes, he saves himself.
Hey, if you don't like it, you shouldn't be here.
Unbelievable intestinal fortitude on the part of both participants.
Sunset Slip.
Stupid, put it on, you won it.
The Hitman Bret Hart, unquestionably one of the greatest Intercontinental Champions of all time. What a matchup, what a matchup.
He's crying, he is crying. I never seen a dog cry.
And standing over the Hitman Bret Hart, the new Intercontinental Champion,
well, you
brother-in-laws. And Davey Boy Smith extends the hand of friendship.
You got him down now, walk him with the belt.
The Hitman Bret Hart turning his back on the hand of the British Bulldog. The matchup that tore the respective families apart.
Why would you shake a guy's hand that beat you?
Oh, no. Diana Klein.
Oh, we're going to have some more here. We're going to go at it. We're not done with each other yet. The mark of a good sore loser.
There it is! Yes! What a SummerSlam! What a matchup! The new Intercontinental Champion, and look at this! Diana joins her husband!
Of course she's happy!
Diana joins her brother! What a matchup! On Crosby! One of the greatest 15 of 15! It's gotta be the greatest SummerSlam of all time. There you see it, Diana, between her husband and her brother. Tears of joy for Diana. What a matchup. What a SummerSlam.
What a family.
Yes, what a family.
One minute there's jealousy running through the family, the next minute they're hugging.
This has been a family affair! This has been SummerSlam!
Here comes the legend killer, Randy Orton. The most dangerous man in sports entertainment today. Randy Orton is coming for the WWE Championship.
I have a whole bunch of receipts to cash in.
The passion and desire of Drew McIntyre.
I don't see a leader standing before me. I see a selfish SummerSlam, I'm gonna rip off your head.
The sadistic legend killer, Orton and McIntyre for the WWE Championship. You will never see it coming.
The British Bulldog was able to dethrone one of the greatest champions the WWE has ever seen in Bret the Hitman Hart, winning the hearts of his fellow countrymen. However, the Bulldog's reign was short-lived because just 2 months later, as Saturday night's main event returned to network television for the last time during the 1990s, Bulldog was unseated as the Intercontinental Champion by the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels.
We got a new Intercontinental Champion!
After vacating the title in the fall of 1993, Michaels stepped onto the grandest stage of them all, looking to become a three-time Intercontinental Champion at WrestleMania 10, taking on the bad guy, Razor Ramon. Much to his chagrin, HBK would come up short in one of the greatest ladder matches in sports entertainment history. Fast forward to the 1995 SummerSlam. The Intercontinental Championship was once again, quite literally, hanging in the balance.
Both men with the opportunity to make WWF wrestling history here tonight. Two great competitors, Shawn Michaels, unquestionably one of the greatest athletes to ever step into the ring of the World Wrestling Federation, against the bad guy, Razor Ramon. You can feel this anticipation, this electricity. Joining me now, ladies and gentlemen, in the broadcast position, Doc Hendricks. Doc, unbelievable action thus far here tonight.
I just can't believe it. When they say there's nothing hotter than SummerSlam, they ain't lying. And I'm going to tell you right now, I couldn't leave you in a lurch. I had to come out and help you.
In a lurch?
In a lurch. You know, I've been carrying you for months on Superstars. Don't thank me now. Let's get to this match. I can't wait to see this match.
All right, here we go. Hanging in the balance, the Intercontinental Championship belt. Yes, it is glistening from high above. A ladder will be needed to come into the ring. And wait a minute, what we have here is the officials protesting. You would have to be Andre the Giant and have a jetpack on your back to be able to reach that. So now, this is going to have to be positioned.
You know, an interesting point about SummerSlam, this is the eighth SummerSlam, and in the previous seven, the Intercontinental title has swapped hands. It's been a hot potato with the exception of 1993.
It has indeed been a very, very hot potato. And wait a minute now, Shawn Michaels says lift it up. Wait a minute, what's this about? All right. In any event, both men looking up. The bell has rung. And Razor wants it. So does Michaels. I mean, that championship belt is way up there. A little consultation going on now. Two men. You have worn the gold. Don't look for a penny man. Oh, my goodness.
All right.
Razor, hand me away on Michael. Razor now. Being set up. Razor off the rope. Over Michael. Look at this. Unbelievable. Look at that. Whoa, look at the skill. Look at the speed of Michael's missing with a kick. Razor hanging on the rope. He knew it was coming.
Razor Ramon has got to watch out for that sweet chin music.
If Michaels nails Razor with a kick, he's going to go out.
Oh, yes. If I'm Razor Ramon, I attack the legs of Shawn Michaels. I take that offensive weapon away immediately.
Locking back up now. Around house with nobody home and Shawn Michaels. He's so quick. Michaels with a quick left and a right. Oh, look out. Reversal. No, Michaels puts on the brakes, but nobody's there. Razor with a door. Oh, no, no. Oh, oh, baby. Razor's edge almost applied. Did you see that backdoor reverse?
Yes, I did.
Whoa. Both men, quick?
Both men trying to end it early. They've both Michaels. Obviously done their homework.
Oh, no question about that. They have come here, ladies and gentlemen, to have a go at it. And that will do. Michaels winding up the bad guy. Razor Ramon with a bit of a reversal there. Working on the left arm and shoulder. Razor, the larger of the two. Razor now. Uh-oh, on the receiving end of a right hand and another. Michaels pitches up. Lefts and rights with a lot of technical skill and... Oh, no!
Wow! Now that was power on the part of Razor Ramon. And he's going to get the ladder. You got to remember, Razor Ramon's 6'7". It's going to be easy for him to reach the belt and Shawn Michaels.
Razor Ramon is coming after him. And again, ladies and gentlemen, he has to cut this match. It's simply to retrieve the ladder, bring it back in the ring, and grab the Intercontinental Championship belt from high above and make it off. And then from there, if you're the holder of the Intercontinental belt, you're the winner.
And here we go,
and... No, don't tell me. Michael!
Oh! Oh! I might suggest that's it.
Yes, that is it.
No, wait a minute. Michaels is moving.
Oh, right there! Get him!
Do it again!
Shawn Michaels, unquestionably the most resilient athlete in the history of the World Wrestling Federation. Michaels now thrown back in. Let's go to a double feature if we have it. Razor back in. That's live action on the right. Look at this. Michaels all the way over the top. Michaels down. Look at that. Unbelievable. Back to live action. Michaels on his feet. Maybe not for long. Here we go.
Bye-bye. Michaels. Yes, right on the other side. Michaels missing with a boot. And a double toe by him. Both men go down.
Unbelievable.
This I thought that was going to be it.
I did too. Both of them giving it their all. Who are you rooting for?
I just hope both men come out of this all right. Both men.
Not a chance.
Great competitors. There was no question. At WrestleMania 10, that particular ladder match that both men were involved in before took extraordinary sums out of each contestant, out of each athlete. I didn't think it'd ever be the same again, and maybe they weren't.
Razor, reversing it.
Razor. Whipping Michaels. This time high above.
Oh, no.
Oh! Look at this! Yeah. Razor with Michaels! Yes!
Unbelievable! I'll tell you who the big winner here is tonight. It's going to end up being Psycho Sid, because he's got to be relishing this as he watches this.
No question about that. Psycho Sid will meet the winner of this matchup on September 11th. It'll be a Monday Night Raw. Sid to meet either Razor Ramon or Shawn Michaels. And here it comes. Razor's going to bring the ladder into the ring. So Razor, the first man to put the ladder in play.
Come on, Razor.
Razor bringing the ladder to the ring. Wait a minute. Psycho Sid looking on. Watching live action. Let's go back out to the arena. And look at the... Oh!
Oh.
Michaels!
Oh!
Psycho Sid watching this matchup. Who will he face and in what condition will that individual be? Wait a minute, here we go.
Here he goes, four-time Intercontinental Champion. History in the making. Climbing the stairway to heaven.
Climbing up, reaching for it, and now. Wow. Shawn Michaels coming in just in the nick of time.
Okay, come on, Shawn.
You're rooting for Shawn to win.
No, I don't care.
The ladder in play now. Oh, wait a minute. Michaels, what's he gonna do with the ladder? Michaels, inadvertently. Or was it inadvertent? I think it was.
I think he meant to do it.
Hailing Razor Ramon. No, I don't think so. He's trying to set the ladder back up. Here we go. Michaels is gonna retrieve the belt. Michaels going upstairs. Razor trying to grab the ladder. He has an ankle. He has two ankles. Razor kicked off.
It's a full moon.
Razor. Can't stop. Shawn Michaels. Oh, no. Oh, oh. Just sit down.
He had to tear his knee on that bench. How could the ladder take the punishment?
I don't know, but Shawn Michaels really wrenched his knee as Razor yanked him off the ladder.
And that's got to take away the super kick.
Look at this. Razor, what's he going to do? Let's go back another level, teacher, if we have it. Razor taking advantage of the unfortunate incident here with Shawn Michaels. Oh, wow. Unbelievable. That's live action on the right. Look at this. Michaels catches his leg and wrenches that knee. Back to more action. Oh, no.
This is such an intelligent move on Razor Ramon's part. Shawn's leg is injured, thus it will hamper him or totally annihilate him from being able to complete his super kick.
Michaels in big trouble now. Shawn Michaels, ladies and gentlemen, coming to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
Come on, Razor.
You just said come on Shawn earlier.
I know, see, I'm very objective.
Again, the ladder is in play. Unfortunately for Shawn Michaels. And Razor Ramon, with his aggressive tactics, receiving a few boos here from this capacity crowd. But that's what it's all about as Razor tries to win. Wait a minute. I'm not so sure about that.
I think he slipped.
Was Razor trying to set the ladder up? Or was he trying to hit Shawn Michaels? Razor Ramon will make sure that Michaels will not be able to climb the ladder. Oh no, here it comes. A scoop. Oh!
That's it.
Razor Ramon will make sure that Shawn Michaels will not climb the ladder all right. I'm not so sure that Michaels will ever be the same.
This is great. I got the best seat in the house.
Razor Ramon with very aggressive tactics here. Razor with Shawn Michaels now, right where he wants him. What's he going to do? Whips him to the ladder. No, he can't whip him into the ladder. Razor had the ladder set up. The bad guy. Oh, my goodness. Is he ever working on that limb? Look at that.
Very intelligent.
That's space. If Michaels cannot stand up, he certainly can't climb a ladder. Oh my goodness. Razor driving a knee into the hamstring area.
He asked him, was he willing to put his body on the line?
Oh no, wait a minute. Razor with bad ribs and all just took a shot right in the rib for the ladder. But can Michaels capitalize? He's trying to get back up. No. Michaels, yes, that knee bending. Oh, no. Ramon with Michaels up in. Oh.
The bad guy is being beautifully bad.
Razor Ramon wants to be the first man to ever be the fourth-time Intercontinental Champion. And I guess maybe he's pulling out all the stops. And that. Again, highly unusual WWF action here at SummerSlam. We've seen a casket match. And here in the ladder match, anything goes as well.
Well, I wonder how Bret Hart is.
Wait a minute, look at this. Over the top, can he get it out there? Oh, no. Razor. Oh, good.
Razor Ramon will not be denied here, Vinnie Mac.
Razor Ramon. Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Razor Ramon continuing to make sure Michaels will not be the victor. And no one knows Shawn Michaels any better than Razor Ramon. Razor knows of the tenacity. Razor knows of the perseverance of Shawn Michaels. Razor Ramon is not taking any chances, and I can't believe Michaels is on his feet. Shawn with a right hand. Another. Razor set up. Michaels over the rope and drop toe. Nicely done.
Smart wrestling maneuver there.
Wait a minute.
I am super impressed here.
17 months ago, it was Razor Ramon and Shawn Michaels. The ladder match in Madison Square Garden. It was Razor Ramon the victor. And it appears as though there will be the same result here.
Let's not forget, last year at SummerSlam, Razor Ramon won the Intercontinental title there.
Yes, indeed. All right, it comes to ladder again.
I feel for Shawn.
I don't think that was an accident. I don't think that was an accident.
And they're playing for keeps here.
Razor Ramon with a boot to the midsection. And now Michael's pretty much out of this thing.
Oh,
it's Razor. Sets up the ladder. Razor gonna start the clock. Razor Ramon going upstairs. Wait a minute. Michaels is hoisting himself in his hands. Michaels. Oh, my goodness.
That's why they call him the Heartbreak Kid. Nobody's got more heart than Shawn Michaels.
I'll grant you that. A desperate move on the part of Shawn Michaels, nonetheless successful.
Come on, Shawn.
You were rooting for Razor a moment ago.
I told you, I don't care. It's just the greatest match I've ever seen.
Razor Ramon and Shawn Michaels going at it. Pittsburgh, SummerSlam. And I'm not so sure that I was not intentional on the part of Michaels.
Who can blame him?
Shawn Michaels with that left leg, obviously screaming in pain. Nonetheless, Michaels, no quit in this man. Both Michaels and Razor making their way back to the ladder.
Psycho Sid has to be licking his chops.
Here we are. Razor Ramon. Hurry up. Michaels better do something quick. Michaels climbing up. Michaels and Razor Ramon. And oh! Well, that took a tremendous sum, I'm sure. A lot of damage to Razor, but Michaels himself, by delivering that blow, had to feel it as well, but Michaels is on his feet. Michaels holding, wait a minute, what's he doing with the ladder? He folds it up.
Uh-oh.
Michaels folding up the ladder. Michaels blocks a right and retaliates, and again. And again, Michaels now with some steam. Ramon to the line. Oh, no. Reversal. No, reversed again.
Oh.
Razor Ramon in trouble. Michaels puts the ladder in the other corner. Ramon. Yes. Scoops up Razor.
Slammed him down to the canvas.
Now what's going to happen?
Lord only knows.
Michaels sets up the ladder. Michaels trying to... Wait a minute, what's he doing? He's going... Why is he going upstairs there?
Don't tell
me. He's going to make a leap. Michaels is going to make a leap. Michaels! There we go! Michaels sucked him out. Or can Michaels, with his athletic ability, can he leap from the top of the rung of the ladder and grab the belt?
High risk.
Michaels from the top. What's going to happen? Michaels, no.
He should have gone for it when he had a chance, Vinnie Mac. Come on, Razor.
Both men knew full well that neither likely to be the same after this match was over. And there's no question about that. And no one has been victorious yet. Who knows how long this match is going to go? And as you brought it out earlier on, it's Psycho Sid. Back in the locker room area, watching this matchup. And here we go with a double feature again. Razor, look at that. Unbelievable. Back to live action on the right of the screen. It's Razor with the ladder. Razor recovering. Razor is going to go upstairs.
Don't tell me they're both going to try to climb it.
There we go again, another shot. And what Shawn Michaels did earlier in, no one there. Moving out of the way just in the nick of time. But now, both men try to lead us on opposite sides of the ladder. They're going up.
Come on, Shawn. Come on, Razor. Come on, Shawn. Come on, Razor.
Razor among the taller of the two. Michaels, perhaps the gutsier, I'm not sure. The tension builds and builds. A right hand. A retaliation. Another one.
Good. Good.
Both men hammering him. Oh, my goodness. Look at that. Headbutt. Whoever stays up, no. Oh, no. And Michaels straddling the top rope as Razor Ramon drops to the outside.
Psycho Sid and the Million Dollar Man have to be dancing in the streets.
Unbelievable.
Well, whoever wins this is going to lose the title on September 11th, no doubt.
Razor Ramon starting to move. Does he have the gumption to get back into the ring? Can Shawn Michaels get back up? After straddling those top rope, wait a minute, let's go back and take a look at it again. Look at this. Oh my goodness, devastating. Back to live action, it's Michaels with the ladder. Razor getting back up. Unbelievable tenacity. Michaels, oh no. Michaels tried, I believe, to hit Razor, he did not.
He went for broke, and I'd say he's busted.
Both men having to take a risk. Razor underneath the ring. Shawn Michaels and Razor Ramon. They'll never be the same. Not after this one. Interim WWF president, Gorilla Monsoon, ordered the ladder match. After the Shawn Michaels Psycho Sid match had been announced, Monsoon said, no, that's not what the WWF fans want to see. They want to see a ladder match. And that's what we have here tonight, live from Pittsburgh
at SummerSlam. What a match.
I'd say if I was DiBiase and Psycho Sid, it was a blessing in disguise, changing the match.
It may have been. Psycho Sid, though, extremely upset. Wait a minute, what's he doing?
What's Razor?
Hey, wait a minute. Razor Ramon is pulling out that
standby ladder.
Razor Ramon, when he was under the ring, when he looked under the ring, saw the standby ladder in the event the first one broke. What's this? I've never seen this before. Michaels sets the ladder up. Michaels going up. Razor back on his feet. Can he stop Michaels?
He better.
Oh, goodness, did you hear that and see that? Oh, no, wait a minute.
Razor's edge. Bye-bye.
Michaels is down.
Well, you got to give it to Shawn. He gave it his all.
Shawn Michaels on the receiving end of the Razor's edge. But Razor can't capitalize. He's had too much taken out of him.
Oh. You hate to see someone lose a match like this.
Razor Ramon pulled out that standby ladder. Yes, we are live. We're in the igloo a record-setting crowd watching this extraordinary, historic event. And Michaels may be out for good. Razor
starting the move.
Razor him up. Trying to get himself together. Looks up at the Intercontinental Championship belt.
Come on, Razor.
Razor Ramon now. What's he gonna do?
Hopefully put the ladder up and go get it.
Razor looking upstairs. Has a standby ladder. I'm not so sure which one of the two. Or which one is the legal ladder, or does it matter? I don't know. We've never seen this before. Ramon.
And there it is.
Sets up his own ladder. Razor Ramon. It's gonna go up. Shawn Michaels, wait a minute. Michaels starting to move. I can't believe it. Shawn Michaels inching over. Razor now.
Come on, Razor.
Wait a minute. Look at this. Michaels. Michaels trying to get up.
Come on, Shawn.
Shawn Michaels climbing his ladder. Razor climbing the opposite ladder. Who's gonna get there first?
Razor's taller.
Razor just got it. Oh, a kick and Razor goes down.
Shawn.
Can Michaels get it? No, he can't get it either. And Michaels is hurt. Unbelievable.
So close yet so far.
Both men down. I thought we had seen it all in the first ladder match. We hadn't.
No, not indeed.
Michaels. Oh, no. Wait a minute. Here it comes. Razor's edge. Oh, no. Can Michaels do it? Now this shot. Now this chance.
Come on, shot.
Michaels going out.
Michaels
somehow putting one foot in front of the other. Michaels can't reach it. Michaels going up again.
Come on,
Michaels down. Can he do it? Yes.
No.
No.
He can't do it. Off.
He can't do it. Michaels down. Beside himself. Look at this. Can he do it this time? Razor's starting to move.
And he got it. He got it. He got it. Wow.
Wait a minute. Look at Razor. Razor, what's going to happen? Razor grabs the Intercontinental Championship belt.
Hit him. Hit him. Stop it. Why?
Rips in an extraordinarily athletic event here. Razor spins Shawn Michaels around.
Come on, hit him, hit him, hit him.
Razor
hands him the Intercontinental Championship belt.
Look at this. Yes.
That's what it's all about.
Oh. That's what it's all about for sure.
One of the most
competitive WWF matches ever.
They took it to each other.
Michaels, Razor Ramon, unquestionably. Rematch of the century could very well be. Shawn Michaels, deservingly. Intercontinental Championship belt over his shoulder. The most resilient Pro Wrestling Federation superstar there is today. Unquestionably, the most flamboyant as well. And some would even say the most athletic.
He is awake. wants something that Braun has.
I am more than a man. I am the thing that nightmares are made of.
The monster, Braun Strowman. The diabolical fiend, Bray Wyatt. For the Universal Championship. WWE SummerSlam. You'll never see it coming.
Shawn Michaels and Razor Ramon would change the game in their second of two iconic ladder matches that would pave the way for future WWE superstars. Just 3 years later, at the 1998 SummerSlam, fellow DX founding father Triple H would create summertime magic of his own when he ascended the ladder of greatness while battling the great one, The Rock.
Helmsley, like a jabber, was thrown right into the ladder.
With the Attitude Era in full force, psychological warfare was the name of the game in the summer of 1998 between two of WWE's most iconic superstars. The highway to hell would lead to Madison Square Garden for the main event of the 1998 SummerSlam as Stone Cold Steve Austin put his WWE Championship on the line against the man from the dark side, The Undertaker.
Business has picked up. Austin starting off very aggressively here. I don't think Austin wants to get into a slugfest with a man that outweighs him about 70 pounds.
Whoa, look at this.
Oh, what shots. Rights and lefts by The Undertaker. And our referee, Earl Hebner, keeping his safe distance from the Phenom.
This is just what you expect out of these two guys. They're going to come in here throwing bombs, trying to put one or the other out early. Look at this.
A rattlesnake strikes back. Oh, what a reversal at the last minute. And a knockdown from the clothesline by the challenger. Undertaker going for it, and Austin kicks out of two.
Whoa! And he gave him two birds.
Collar and elbow tie up. The Undertaker with a huge leverage and strength advantage over Stone Cold Steve Austin. Austin at 252, The Undertaker at 325 pounds. And it will be interesting to see the strategy as it begins to unfold in this matchup. You got to think that Austin may try to work on that vertical base of his 7-foot challenger.
Well, I think The Undertaker right now would like to rip Austin's arm off and beat him over the head with it. Same goes for Austin.
Oh, Austin got a handful of tights. Austin said he'll get it any way he can here.
He does. A drop toe hold.
Austin adding an old move, but a new one to him, to his repertoire. You can believe it, these men were former tag team champions until just a couple of weeks ago.
A smart move, because I guarantee you that's probably the last thing on earth The Undertaker thought he'd see from Stone Cold Steve Austin in a match like this.
King, we've seen a lot of unusual things here tonight, quite frankly. And I still am not totally comfortable with the King factor. He's here. We saw Kane, and we have no word. Mankind is still receiving medical attention. From what we understand, medical people were here in the arena.
Well, who can be comfortable with the Kane factor? I think that Mr. McMahon doesn't want Stone Cold Steve Austin to be comfortable. I think he wants that to be weighing on Austin's mind throughout this entire match, so that maybe Austin is not thinking about The Undertaker the way he should be.
Oh, Undertaker lowered their head.
I think they headbutted each other.
Yeah, I do too. I think Austin got cracked right in the head by The Undertaker. Austin's hit far side. Comes off with a vengeance going downstairs. And
oh man.
Undertaker with that leverage advantage and power. Able to counter. He countered the suplex, did the challenger.
No.
Undertaker, a vicious elbow right to Austin's jaw. That's 325 pounds coming down at you.
Oh, man.
Undertaker left his feet. Austin able to move out of the way.
I'll tell you, JR, you got to say this is pick 'em time. I mean, there's absolutely no way to tell what's going to happen between these two individuals.
And let's just hope it stays one-on-one. Oh, bear hug. Oh, the hot shot.
Man.
I thought Austin was going to tip the Luthes press. The Undertaker caught Austin in midair, and the champion was hot-shotted right over the top rope. Will that be enough there? Austin's, he may be out of it. Taker got the leg hook, and a 2.5. Well, that has the crowd buzzing here. Austin got dinged, I think, on that when their heads collided.
Yeah, I don't think he's been exactly right since.
Undertaker now focusing on Austin's back. Slowed down has this pace dictated by the methodical Phenom. Extended fingers right into the throat of Austin. And look at Bigfoot. Got to be a size 18 or so. Right into the kidneys and the lower back of the WWF champion.
Now at this pace, who does this match favor? It's got to favor the Undertaker.
I think so.
He's bigger, probably stronger.
Austin, no doubt, the quicker of the two. But, oh, that whiplash effect, not going to do your neck any good or your back. Undertaker, boy, he's done no margin for error. But those are well-placed, well-aimed kicks.
Well, the Undertaker's been his own man
here.
Coming into this match.
Oh, Austin, right on the knees. That knee joint of the Undertaker taking a pounding here.
See, I would have thought if the Undertaker had been smart, he'd have gone along with McMahon. But no, he didn't. He gave McMahon a choke slam.
Look out here. Austin, retaliation.
No!
Wrapping the Undertaker's leg right around the ring post. And that's how you fell a giant redwood.
No.
You chop it down. Undertaker's not 6'11 or 7 feet now. He is back up on his feet. Well, Undertaker's trying to get some distance with him and Austin. And look at the Austin's like a machine.
To launch himself right through the air and into Stone Cold Steve Austin's face.
The flying clothesline from an airborne Undertaker found its mark. And now nothing but a chokehold.
When that big gloved fist wraps around your throat, believe me, all the oxygen goes out of your body and no more comes in.
Undertaker would have no problems palming a basketball. Hell, I think he could palm an anvil. Challenger, the Undertaker, putting a lot of torque on the shoulder of Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Oh, here we go. Patented Undertaker. This is sending a message to Stone Cold right here. He's saying, you know, he knows.
Austin had it scouted.
A message to the Undertaker.
Austin right back on that knee. Austin back on that left knee of the Undertaker. Stomping the hamstring. Stomping the knee. He's stomping whatever moves for Stone Cold Steve Austin. Oh, wait a minute. Here comes a damn big red machine. The Demon Kane. The Demon Seed. Austin sees him. Everybody sees that man.
I knew something was going to happen, JR. He was here. Something was bound to happen.
Austin cannot contend with 2 7-foot monsters. It's physically impossible. Not even Austin could do it.
Wait a minute. The Undertaker is... He's telling Kane to go back.
The Undertaker is telling his brother, this is going to be one-on-one. You lead. An Undertaker inviting Austin in. No second invitation needed. It's a slugfest here.
Austin's mouth and lip is busted already. Now he's trying to, in turn, bust the Undertaker. I can't believe that Kane is going.
Kane is heeding the warning, the advice, the instruction of his older brother, and Kane is leaving. But will that be the last time we see him?
Right. Will he be back?
Undertaker's left knee again. Wrenched on the edge of the ring, and Austin making sure Kane is gone. The Undertaker wasn't enough to contend with. Oh my! Chokeslam! Chokeslam! Oh my God! A running chokeslam from the outside!
And then, new champion! I told you, JR!
That is absolutely uncanny, unbelievable power from the number one contender for the World Wrestling Federation title.
I'm telling you, Austin had to have Kane in the back of his head. He took his eyes off the Undertaker, and the Undertaker slammed the back of Kane, or Austin's head, right into that ring floor.
And Austin took a shot on his upper shoulders in the back of his head. And look,
oh no!
Right out here. A clothesline. Undertaker laid it on his feet, but that knee is about to give out on him. Austin and the Undertaker have taken it outside here. Oh. The referee's right out there with him. Man, let's don't have any countouts here.
I think referee Earl Hebner knows how important this match is.
Where in the hell are they going?
What?
Undertaker and Austin are fighting up to the crowd here at the Garden.
Are they nuts? This is New York.
The intent of the Undertaker certainly very well pronounced here.
Well, who would blame him?
When the WWF title's on the line, how can you blame anybody for doing anything to win that prize?
Stunner!
Undertaker backing out of there.
What a move.
Very wisely. What agility.
Right.
Oh! It caught him midair.
And what power?
Spine first into the ring post. Austin could be paralyzed.
Undertaker said he was going to take what's rightfully his. He feels he should be the WWF champion, and he's going to pull out all stops to reach that goal.
Austin's hurting big time. The Rattlesnake is hurting big time here. The Undertaker at 325, catching the champion in midair, and then aggressively ramming him, spine first, into the ring post.
Right, and that makes me wonder, how is Mr. McMahon going to be able to contend with Undertaker as a champion? I mean, he'll probably get an attitude. It won't be any better than Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Well, I'll tell you what, I think Mr. McMahon would cross that bridge when he came to it, as long as Stone Cold wasn't the champion. Boom! And Austin fight back. My God, he will not quit. Right hands.
Look out!
God. Austin.
Oh, man.
His back went right across the ring.
Well, he did it to himself. He tried to catch himself by hanging over that top rope, but instead he acted as a slingshot and drove his side and back right into the edge of that ring.
Boy, the torque on Austin's back right there was absolutely unbelievable.
Watch it, JR. They're right here in front of us.
His side, his ribs rammed into the ring steps. I have never seen Austin take a pounding like this, even from Kane. What's he doing? Undertaker making some modifications to the announce table over here. Austin in a big trouble here. Undertaker choking Austin on the Spanish announce table.
He's got a choke him out right there on the table.
Referee is doing his best not to disqualify anybody or count anybody out.
Get off that table, Comprende Austin.
Austin is hurt. Austin can barely move.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, no. Oh, no. He's 7 feet. He's 325. The champion. Austin is helpless here.
No way.
Don't do it. No! Good God. My God, they're broken in half. Undertaker and Austin are just beating the hell each other for the WWF title. That table did not give. It looks like a car wreck out here.
Look at this. Nearly 7 feet tall, flying through the air.
A leg drop from the top rope. Look at this, folks.
He smashed right into Austin and blasted him right off the table.
Absolutely unbelievable. The impact. The impact. It's academic now. If the Undertaker can get Austin back in the ring, this son of a gun is over.
Well, the Undertaker's the only one standing, JR. What do you think McMahon's face looked like when the Undertaker flew through the air like that?
Austin is out of it.
We've got to do it. What do you think?
We got a new champion.
Yes. What? This is it.
Oh, no. My God, he won't quit. The toughest SOB in the WWF got a shoulder up. I can't tell you how, but he did it.
Oh, look
Austin
at that.
Spitting up blood. Austin's got some internal injuries. Sorry about that. What a whip. What a whip. Undertaker got his own head on top turnbuckle, but no surcease for Austin. No respite.
Didn't even slow the Undertaker down. Nothing is going to stop him. Oh, that might.
Austin fighting back with every single ounce of being that he has left. Barely able to stand. The champion almost out on his feet here.
Right. It's obvious. Austin is overmatched right now. He's pulling out all the stops, and it's not even slowing the Undertaker down.
A count out means that Austin keeps the belt. Referee's at six. He gets
set
to 10.
Set up, Undertaker.
This
set
is
up
over
for Mr. McMahon.
Oh, whoa. Oh, and Austin kick out. That son of a gun ain't going to stay down. Undertaker's not going to stay down. The war continues.
Look at Austin's face.
The war continues.
Look at Austin's face.
Oh, it's a slugfest. To tee it off on the Undertaker. Ooh, what a chop.
But look at the Undertaker. It's like it's really not having any effect on him.
Oh, this hell way to hell could be the Undertaker's destiny. Wait a minute. Luke F. Prince. Distant fire. Distant fire from the rattlesnake. Oh, what a shot to the throat with that elbow by the champion. Man, this has been grueling. The physical intensity here is unmatched anywhere.
Oh. Oh.
Austin was looking for a stunner. But I think it's the back of his head cracked the Undertaker's face.
It was almost a neck breaker on Austin.
Could be it. That could be it. No, it's not it.
How?
I don't know.
How is Austin even going after going through that table? After the Undertaker smashed him right into that, into the floor, through that table, I can't imagine. Oh! He may not be going any further, JR.
Choke slam. A choke slam by the Undertaker.
Choke slam!
The end is near for Stone Cold Steve Austin. Austin's had neck problems. A tombstone coming up here.
Yes, and a new champion coming up as well.
What? Austin from behind. Undertaker overpowering Austin again. Austin. Oh! Austin straddled the top rope. Undertaker has bought himself some more time. More importantly, the Undertaker's got the advantage again. The WWE title hangs in the balance here.
The Undertaker, he's going to do anything and everything.
Russian leg sweep by the Undertaker. A first for the Phenom.
Which damages your opponent's neck. He's pulling out all stuff, JR. He's going to do anything. He's a monster. Look at him. He can taste it. He can feel it coming. The WWF title is it literally in his hands again. Look at the blood out of the mouth of Stone Cold.
Undertaker is like standing over fallen prey. The wounded Austin. It may be just moments away now from the rattlesnake going down at the hands of the Phenom. Undertaker back on top. This didn't work earlier.
No! Did you see that?
Austin with a low blow. Out of desperation.
Stunner!
He got the stunner. 1, 2. Yes! Yes! The rattlesnake! The rattlesnake! Austin wins! Austin wins!
How did he do that, JR?
He's got the WWE title belt in his hand.
He's gonna bash him.
What's gonna happen here? Oh, this is. What is this? Is this gonna explode or what? The Undertaker just got beat with a stunner.
What?
That takes a hell of a lot of class. That's a man's man right there. And yes, there will be another day. The Undertaker got caught in the stunner. The Undertaker said it would be one-on-one and Kane would not be involved. And the Undertaker kept his word. He did what he said he was going to do. Except he couldn't avoid the Stone Cold Stunner.
Why didn't you listen to McMahon? You could be the champion right now.
Wait a minute, Kane. Or perhaps even Kane.
The psychological warfare on the part of The Undertaker proved to be ineffective at rattling the rattlesnake as Stone Cold successfully defended his championship at the 1998 SummerSlam. The epic rivalry between two iconic superstars would continue throughout the late 90s and early 2000s as they traded championship victories in both singles and tag team competition, cementing their legacies in WWE history. Undoubtedly, knocking off one of these legends would be a surefire way to blaze your own path to glory. And that is exactly what one superstar looked to do. For the better part of 2008, The Undertaker and the rated R superstar Edge engaged in an epic series of matches, from main eventing WrestleMania to a brutal TLC match.
A last ride through two tables!
The only way to truly end this heated rivalry was to place these two inside the Devil's favorite playground. What would ensue at the 2008 SummerSlam would go down in history as one of the all-time craziest matches in WWE, and it all took place in the demonic structure known as Hell in a Cell.
Undertaker stalking. Somewhere along the way, Edge is going to lose that smile.
Yeah, well, I think you might be right, but look at this here.
And team up.
Edge picked his spot.
Oh, my God. Not many want to throw hands with The Undertaker, but Edge is doing it. You look back at all the competition that The Undertaker has to beat. Oh, man. And that was a scintillating shot right to the face. I don't know if any athlete in the history of the WWE has given The Undertaker more problems than Edge.
Well, I think you're right about that. Watch this. Straight up boom. Bam! Right in the face. I think that might just be the beginning of the brutality we might witness here.
Physicality personified here in Satan's structure. Over the top.
That's where that's where the problems begin. Once you get outside of the ring structure, then you're around that demonic structure that is just unforgiving. That cell will pick apart your body, which picks apart careers.
The Hell in a Cell is almost like a living being itself. It likes to select its victims. And these two men, before this night is over, The Undertaker and Edge will no doubt become victims of the Hell in a Cell.
Again, the physicality right here, baby. Boom. Spine first into the steel care of the dead man. And JR, I know you've called the first Hell in a Cell match. I mean, in your opinion, has the violence of this match and up over the years.
I think simply because the aggression between The Undertaker and Edge is what makes this Hell in a Cell so special and so unique.
Well, the dead man in complete control. And the intensity of The Undertaker is just unmatched.
You see that chain locking the door. These men are locked inside the structure. Again, it does have a roof on it.
Well, that's no rules, and just imagine the bodily damage The Undertaker can cause in the cell. And I just think we just saw some of that. It's not even comfortable being this close to the cell, JR. This thing's about 10 feet away from us, man, the size of it.
Very intimidating to sit on the outside. One can only imagine what it would be like to be on the inside. I choose not to ever find out.
Yeah, I second that emotion.
There can be no count out to disqualifications here, ladies and gentlemen. That may go without saying. And there is our SmackDown General Manager, Vicky Guerrero, and her family, Chavo Guerrero, Tag Champions Hawks, looking on. Undertaker enjoying this methodical pace that he has set out on to physically dissect his adversary.
Oh, yeah, and again, we talk about physicality and aggression. Look at the dead man, the height. Not only that, the athletic ability, the height of the Undertaker. Oh, boy.
All legal.
completely legal. Steel, the silver, the color of the night.
Not good right now for the rated R superstar here. And what does the dead man have in mind? Bad intentions, I think.
Undertaker placing the ring steps, seemingly where he wanted them. And now where will the Undertaker place Edge? Uh-oh. Here it comes. Like Edge caught himself in the V there, the steps. And now the Undertaker is the one that feels the steps that the Undertaker brought into the ring.
Like it or not, you gotta give Edge credit. That was a phenomenal counter. I thought Edge drove his own head into the steps. And
that basement drop kick driving the Undertaker's head. The spear all against the ring steps. Again, that the Undertaker brought into the ring. And now we're seeing Edge show some innovative and yet destructive offense.
Well, Edge did say that he would show the Undertaker the purest form of hell. And this might be the beginnings of it, JR.
Edge, certainly a tables, ladders, and chairs expert. Here's another
He blocked it, and then Edge was able to stop the Undertaker.
The great counter follows again more usage of these steel steps. Undertaker may be regretting that he brought those steps into play.
Undertaker might not know where he is right about now. But Edge,
it's not one table's obviously not enough for whatever Edge is thinking.
Yeah, look at the spear here while Undertaker's trapped. Nowhere for the dead man to go. Watch.
That steel and cranium coming together. And again, high impact from Edge taking down the Undertaker.
I got to tell you, JR, I am impressed with Edge right now. I'm telling you, man. It just seems like that confidence, you could see it in his face, his eyes. He believes in himself, and that's a huge part of being in a match with The Undertaker in the cell.
I thought coming into this match at Edge in that psychopathic state would be a little bit out of control. But Edge seemingly willing to ravage his own body to win this match. And that's what's Look out here. And it's all about winning and maybe surviving. Undertaker had to be thinking chokeslam. At least that's my assumption.
Well, I think Edge just saved himself right there because the dead man looked like he was going Doozle City to Edge. Now watch.
In the chair. Legal in the first ever Hell in a Cell match in SummerSlam history. So now we have seen a table set up.
Now watch this. Look. Boom! It looks, seemed to be the edge of the chair into the throat of the Undertaker. And that'll definitely incapacitate anybody, even the Undertaker.
Edge making sure he went down, went right for the spine of the Undertaker. And now
Look at Edge's eyes here, JR. Look at it. Talk about aggression and intensity and desire to be victorious. I tell you, I'm impressed with Edge.
Another hard, vile, steel chair shot to the spine. The second one to the Undertaker's spine in this match.
Well, we've seen over the years, though, JR, the Undertaker can sustain punishment. He is tough for that matter.
Undertaker's pain threshold is off the charts. Does it compare with anyone I've ever seen?
I don't know. Edge, he's spending a lot of time. He's grabbing all sorts of furniture under this ring here.
Edge said earlier on SmackDown that his brain was burning from the inside out. But it looks like Edge is certainly a master strategist here tonight.
What is that? It looks like two ladders out here. And as you pointed out, Edge's expertise with TLC matches. We got some tables and we got some ladders and a chair in hand.
And another hard steel chair shot. Certainly was not on the spine, but takes the Undertaker down, and Edge is doing a lot of housekeeping here and rearranging.
Listen, Jay, I have no idea what Edge's game plan is here, his strategy. I have no idea, but he obviously does have some sort of a plan.
We have seen so many transformations and metamorphosis of Edge in the last few weeks. We're seeing another here tonight.
Well, I'll tell you what, JR, you can call Edge twisted, whatever. You can call whatever you want, but this persists tonight. You're going to call him the winner, man, in this Hell in a Cell match.
Edge in his first Hell in a Cell match. Here tonight at SummerSlam against The Undertaker.
Look at Edge here. Look at the aggressiveness. Oh, look at that. You got to be kidding me.
Vile, evil, nasty aggression by the R-rated superstar.
You got to assume that The Undertaker might not have a clue where the heck he is right about now.
But you said earlier, a great point, Undertaker can take a pounding, but how much more can the human anatomy take?
I think Edge is about to test The Undertaker's resiliency for pain.
Remember what Edge did to Mick Foley. And he said the same thing. I understand. Edge said the same thing before he destroyed Mick Foley with that same maneuver. The Undertaker tasting the wood and the steel.
I cannot believe the control that Edge has. Look at this. I understand.
That's scary. That is evil. We had a near fall, our first near fall of the contest. Edge looking for a cover, got a two count. I'm surprised that we haven't seen a pin attempt, but I think what it really illustrates is the mental frame of mind of both these men. Let's maim and destroy.
Well, Edge is just pulling out all the stops, and I'll tell you, like it or not, that's what you have to do.
Oh, wait a minute. We know what's coming now, ladies and gentlemen. It won't be pretty, the concerto. And The Undertaker sets off, saves himself, at least for the time being, in a thunderous right hand.
The heavy-hitting Undertaker just dropped Edge with one straight-up punch. But can The Undertaker capitalize?
And to think that The Undertaker's career, after being banished, received a reprieve from SmackDown's general manager, Mrs. Edge.
All the punishment Edge has given to The Undertaker thus far in this matchup. Oh! Look at that. Well, look at the ribs of all Edge. You see that gigantic, like a big welt, like a swelled up bruise of sorts.
Take a look at this. Watch this.
Hey, look, man. There's nothing pretty about that. Boot meets face, face, and body meets self.
This is a match where casualties are guaranteed. And The Undertaker again. Right the side of the head.
Turnabout fair play, they say, JR.
Edge may have been lucky to turn his head at the last moment, or he'd have been hit right between the eyes with those steel steps. Well, listen to this.
Here it comes.
Again, steel and cranium meet. You don't have to guess who wins.
Edge's spaghetti leg. The dead man, he's not looking too good himself. He's hurting also. Uh-oh.
Oh, The Undertaker's head and shoulder against the steel ring post. Edge able to put on the brakes. Edge saving himself there.
Here he comes. Oh,
Cage is just imploded.
I can't believe what we just witnessed here. The spear through the sand. The impact, as you said, JR.
I got a whole heck of a lot closer to the Hell in a Cell than I ever wanted to be. It's right here on top of us. And look at the right hands. The Undertaker and Edge exchanging right hands.
It's like a street fight right here, JR. Watch out! Oh, well, I gotta
kick.
These two men outside the steel. Where will this one go? How will this
end?
And Edge's head bouncing off the steel.
Well, I'll tell you what, the hell's not only in the cell, the hell's out here.
Edge going for the That steel, that security wall didn't move an inch.
I never expected this, JR. Out of the cell, and it's breaking down worse than in the cell.
And, Undertaker looking to plant Edge in a television monitor. Edge and the Undertaker getting extreme. There's a shot. The crack of that monitor to the Undertaker's head was this.
Definitely slowed down to Devin. Another one. Yeah, look at the impact here.
Look at the impact. Hear the impact. Feel the impact. Again,
Edge just in control here, JR.
Now watch. I want to work.
That's the knock.
Just got speared as Edge ran from east to west, north to south.
I can't believe what I just witnessed. I'm telling you, I'm about 10 feet from it. The impact right now we just witnessed. Insane. Just watch this.
Edge running across two announce tables. What impact. A collision.
Unreal. I can't believe this match, JR. Phenomenal.
These two men, the impact has destroyed the cell. These two men are destroying each other. Are we seeing two amazing careers be drastically shortened here tonight?
Yeah, I think we are. In my opinion, I definitely think we're seeing careers shortened a bit here.
This is amazing. Amazing.
Look at the impact here. God almighty.
Edge wasn't walking on water. He was running on wood. And emotion. And now the Undertaker somehow is back up.
Yeah, right out here in front of us again. Oof. Another look. An insane spear. And a street fight right here in front of us, JR.
Undertaker challenging Edge. The throw in my head. Hit me in the head. Bring it with all you've got.
Let's go, Taker.
I tell you, I don't think either of these men know where they are right now. It's not possible.
This has been an amazing aggression, amazing perseverance, the will to survive, to compete, to win this match at SummerSlam is absolutely, it's unexplainable. Well,
listen, by any means necessary, more or less, the desire of both athletes.
And Edge with that trusty ladder, perhaps his best friend in this match, the ladder striking the Undertaker.
I mean, Vicky, I guess, liking what she's seeing right now, I guess.
I don't know. That's her husband in there still. Better for better or for worse.
Uh-oh. Well, I'll tell you, Edge right now, I didn't think Edge would be able to do what he's done thus far in this match. I am impressed. But
oh, my God, this is Shades of the Last Hell in a Cell match. This is exactly what cost The Undertaker the title at Survivor Series last year inside Hell in a Cell.
All legal, JR.
Edge was
history repeats itself here, JR.
Dressed as a killer man. The cover. Will it be? No, it's not over.
How much closer can you get?
Man, it has been an emotional day here. I know that our general manager for SmackDown, Vicky Guerrero, has been surrounded by her family all day, certainly concerned about what Edge might do during the day.
Yeah, that they've been sequestered. And,
come on,
I think they were just as more as concerned about the Undertaker than the one with the Edge.
Oh, oh boy! Edge thick as beer.
There we go!
Oh, God! Oh, what a choke slam!
Talk about
high lord! What a choke slam!
It's gotta be.
Can it be?
Oh, man!
I'm not believing this.
Did you see how high in the air Edge was?
A slam dunk of a choke slam from the Demon of Death Valley, and Edge was able somehow, some way, to kick out of it.
Oh,
low blow, legal inside, Hell in a Cell. And I'm sure the Cell is enjoying the carnage that we're all witnessing here tonight. The Devil's Playground has indeed been just that.
I'm lost for words. I cannot remember the last time I've witnessed two men in the cell have at it like we're witnessing right now.
The Impaler DDT. Edge now looking to finish off the Undertaker.
I get him with that. I get him here.
He could. And referee Scott Armstrong got a two count. But Edge has a distinct advantage as we speak.
Well, we talked about the amount of punishment that the Undertaker can take. Uh-oh.
This could get ugly. Uglier. Undertaker buried the right hand. A body shot. The double over Edge.
That might have been the most important body shot the Dead Man threw.
Big time body shot. Undertaker.
Uh-oh, woo.
Undertaker, what's...
Oh, no.
Wait a minute. You don't think that... Undertaker.
Whoa.
Oh, Edge off the backside.
God!
Undertaker.
That's it.
It's over. It's over.
Got him.
Is it over?
Got him.
I don't know anymore. I thought it was over. And then you think it's the Undertaker.
We're going to counter here by Edge. And a spear. Another spear to the Dead Man care of Edge.
Edge has brought his spear, his chair, his tables, his ladders. All to throw at the Undertaker.
Hey, listen, and Edge brought his A-game too, JR. Don't forget that. Like it or not, he did, I'm telling you.
I'm not arguing with you. Another right hand. I said earlier that the Undertaker has had more problems with Edge than any other WWE superstar. I think that fact has been proven in this match, if it wasn't before.
And no doubt that Edge has rented a lot of space in the head of Undertaker.
Undertaker. The last ride!
Got it!
Will it be the last ride? Will it go? The journey continues. What we thought was the literal last ride for the Undertaker.
How did Edge kick out of the last ride? Had to be on instinct. Had to be.
I thought the Undertaker delivering that last ride would have essentially been last rites in a figure of speech. And now the Undertaker thinking something else. Undertaker's trying to use these steel steps on more than one occasion tonight and has effectively.
No, JR, I gotta be thinking it's not just instinct on Edge's part. It's the frame of mind, the frenzy. He's just been off the wall and he just wants to win this match so bad. And I guess that's how he's able to kick out of stuff that the Dead Man is doing to him.
We thought Edge being psychotic. We thought Edge was willing to see his own body ravaged to win this match, to pay the supreme price. But it may not be that. Undertaker now, play up on that steel steps like a platform, like a gold medal platform.
Gotta be kidding here.
Undertaker. Remember those steel chair shots to the spine earlier in this match? The Undertaker just, his spine met steel again, this time the ring steps. At some point, his back is going to forgive. It's going to give out.
I think that point might be right about now. Edge looks like he counted the tombstone piledriver. And as you said, you got to wonder the condition of the spine of the Dead Man. Here we go. Both men are spent, JR. Just spent.
I don't know how these two men are continuing to compete in this environment after what they put each other through. And this match seemingly is far from over.
You're not kidding.
Edge, look, I'm weary. Look, can't even hardly stand up. The dead man probably don't even know where he is.
Undertaker's back, his spine has got to be hurting him immensely. Undertaker, you can see he's not even standing. And there's those free shots with the Undertaker on his knees.
When was the last time you saw the dead man in this bad of shape during a matchup? Oh, wait a minute. Whoa.
This is sacrilege. Edge going old school.
Oh.
And school is out. No recess for Edge, who tried to go old school on the Undertaker. And the right hand by.
Well, that was an uppercut that was nasty. Wait a minute.
Chokeslam through the table to the floor.
Tables, two tables, JR. Edge looks like he fell off the top of a building.
Man, if that doesn't do it, if this doesn't do it here after being chokeslammed through two tables.
Check this out. How do you explain this? What do you think Edge was thinking in mid-flight? There's no count, there's nothing you can do.
Undertaker now measuring Edge, who is back to the ring. Undertaker with a spear, a page out of Edge's book. Retaliation from the dead man using Edge's spear on Edge.
I got to think right there during this insanely physical battle.
First the tables, then the spear, and now the count! Man, that was more than HD. That's human devastation, all right, if that's the HD you're looking at.
Jarrell, look at this. It's almost like everything that Edge has done to the dead man, the dead man is doing to Edge.
The Undertaker revisiting.
No,
he's tied for the concerto. The Undertaker, to my knowledge, has never used a concerto in his almost two-decade career. This is all a receipt sent back to Edge, a message. You paid for your sins, and now the
Tombstone.
The conscience of the WWE wins Hell in a Cell.
The Undertaker!
One of the most amazing physical confrontations in WWE history. The physicality and the aggression that we have seen from both these men. It's indescribable, but at the end of the day, the greatest of them all, The Undertaker, is the winner in Hell in a Cell.
Well, we heard Edge say, I'm going to pull The Undertaker down to hell with me, and Vicky, you too. That didn't happen. The dead man, successful.
Vicky, surrounded all day by her family, in fear of the actions of her own husband. But The Undertaker, his legacy has grown to even more unworldly heights here tonight.
What a match it was though, JR. What a physical contest we witnessed. An amazing Hell in a Cell. There's life in Edge yet, though. Not much.
Edge moving around. The Undertaker saw it on the screen, apparently. And the demon of Death Valley apparently thinks that his night's work has yet to finish. We saw tables, we saw chairs, we saw the camera, we saw spears, and now we are seeing a ladder.
Yeah, we saw concertos, and I think Edge might be seeing the back of his eyelids shortly.
This match is officially over.
Oh, man. I have no clue what.
Edge is helpless. Edge is out of it. Edge is completely.
Edge is just laying up on the ladder, just like stuck there. Can't even help himself.
Edge is unable to defend himself whatsoever. But what is the Undertaker thinking here now?
It's almost like Edge is melting off the ladder. He's here.
Payback is a steep, steep price sometimes. And
what is going on here? The dead man.
We've talked about individuals with mean streaks, with tenacity.
Legend killer Randy Orton, the most dangerous man in sports entertainment today. Randy Orton is coming for the WWE Championship.
I have a whole bunch of receipts to cash in.
The passion and desire of Drew McIntyre.
I don't see a leader standing before me. I see a selfish. At SummerSlam, I'm gonna rip off your head.
The sadistic legend killer, Orton and McIntyre for the WWE Championship. You will never see it coming.
The Undertaker came away with a successful victory in one of the wildest matches the WWE Universe has ever witnessed, proving that there's no substitution for main event experience at the biggest blockbuster of the summer. Speaking of legends and main eventers, a man who is certainly no stranger to main eventing SummerSlam is John Cena. Win, lose, or draw, when John Cena hits the ring, you're in for one hell of a ride. But as we've seen from both Randy Orton and Brock Lesnar, you can never count out a young superstar with tons of momentum. And there was no one in WWE that had more momentum in the summer of 2013 than the leader of the Yes Movement, Daniel Bryan. With the WWE Championship on the line, Bryan would not only have to overcome Cena's main event experience, but there was no telling what would happen when the game, Triple H, served as the special guest referee.
And the question is, for Daniel Bryan tonight, will he become the next John Cena? Will he become the next Rock? Or will he become the first Daniel Bryan?
John Cena won his first WWE Championship right here in the Staples Center. Will he lose his 11th right here in the Staples Center?
Won his first title against the man sitting to my right, John Bradshaw Layfield. And it's Cena and Bryan, one-on-one for the WWE title in the biggest match in the career of Daniel Bryan.
Oh my gosh, guys, I don't know about you. Hair standing up on the back of my neck here.
John Cena.
This is gonna be good.
His 10th straight match at SummerSlam. And Daniel Bryan, now we want to point out, you see that John Cena's left elbow is heavily wrapped. That is because Cena has a swollen and distended elbow. It's like a baseball is stuck in his left elbow, according to Cena. Been taped up, he says he's fine here tonight, but you have to believe, guys, that a submission specialist like Daniel Bryan will target that elbow of John Cena.
Well, you know Cena's gonna say it's fine. That's why it's John Cena. We'll find out if it really is.
For Daniel Bryan, this match is played out like this. Daniel Bryan, the wrestler, against Cena, the entertainer. Does John Cena want to get in a, quote, wrestling match with Daniel Bryan, Kenny?
I don't think John Cena has any problem in any kind of match with Daniel Bryan. John Cena picked Daniel Bryan as his opponent here tonight in SummerSlam. So I don't think John Cena fears Daniel Bryan in any way, shape, form, or fashion.
Yeah, but true to John Cena, picked Daniel Bryan because he was the hottest WWE superstar on the roster.
And he is the hottest on the roster. Daniel Bryan in short history of SummerSlam. Very, very impressive. Cena, nice takedown again, shoulders down by Bryan. Kick out.
And Daniel may be hot, but he's still 210 pounds and looks like a goat against 11-time WWE champion.
Hey, and look at Cena. Triple H, special guest referee, perfect position as well. Daniel Bryan holding his own. Daniel Bryan. And there goes John Cena, monkey flip by Bryan. Daniel Bryan going for the elbow, went for the S-lock early. John Cena smart, wise move by the champ. That is our ringside doctor who is sitting next to King here, to King's left. John Cena just whispered something in the ear to Dr. Heyman, and I wonder what that was all about.
Wouldn't it be bad for me to ask Dr. Heyman what he just said?
Go right ahead.
You're fired, King.
Doc, can you tell us what he said? Can you tell us what he said? How about that?
Yeah, well, John Cena apparently told the doc his elbow's fine.
That's how you translate that?
He's celebrating. He's already celebrating. I'm telling you, John Cena feels confident about this match.
Why shouldn't he? And the all-time greats.
I mean, we heard our illustrious panel. We heard the man that helped train Daniel Bryan. We heard Shawn Michaels say that Daniel Bryan can win. Yes, he can win.
And you know, John, you made a great point there. There's a reason that John Cena is using his left arm for the headlock here. And they take down Daniel Bryan. Show off the elbow's not hurt.
But John Cena's one of the toughest WWE competitors of all time.
And look at Cena. And Daniel Bryan looking to reverse it. Manages to get his shoulder up. But again, John Cena using the weight to his advantage. Cena gonna have the physical advantage in this. Daniel Bryan, though. Nice bridge out, nice reversal, whoa, slide on Cena. Shoulders down on the champ, and a two kick out.
Cena's record also says...
And Bryan, nice leg takedown by Daniel Bryan.
Cena's record also says he's one of the greatest WWE superstars of all time.
Right.
And I know John, he says it almost fine. I'm not sure it is.
Daniel Bryan now.
No.
Who claims he has more than 100 ways to make a man tap out. Is this one of them here? John Cena trying to prevent his arms from being stripped here by Bryan.
Yeah.
And Bryan, literally Cena powering out.
What a strength from John Cena.
Look out, Daniel Bryan! Announce table. Oh, and Bryan hit hard. Daniel Bryan hit hard.
Did he ever? Check this out one more time and listen to the landing.
And Bryan went on. See,
soon to be ribs first King into the side of the announce table. And Cena's going to show no mercy tonight. Cena's the champ. His championship's on the line. It's about being champ. It's about being top of the heap. John Cena, though, shoulder elbow first into the steps.
Daniel Bryan can't win a championship outside the ring, though.
No, he's got to pin the champ or make him submit. Just an incredible atmosphere all night long here at the Staples Center. It's John Cena with a block. Now Daniel Bryan pays for it off the top of the steel steps.
That's strength. That's just a matter of size difference between John Cena and Daniel Bryan.
Bryan into the ring, quickly into the cover. Looks to put Bryan away as he hooks the leg, and Bryan needs two before he kicks out.
One thing I like about the fact that Triple H is refereeing this match is the fact that, you know, I mean, the game's going to give some leeway. He's going to let these guys go. That's the way the WWE Universe wants it. I think that's the way both these superstars want it.
Triple H knows what it means to be in championship matches, to be the main event at SummerSlam, the importance of this night. For not only Cena, but the young career of Daniel Bryan. Cena will win a power game. There's no doubt about that, and that's on display now. You can do all the moves you want, but sometimes power just prevails.
Yep, you're right about that.
Can't coach speed, and you can't coach power. That's something that's awful hard to counter. I don't care how many wrestling moves you know.
Now this place, the Staples Center, has been electric all night long.
But it's something about the presence
look
of John Cena.
Look at all move! Wow. Is it enough? Cena to the cover. Looking to put Daniel Bryan away. Powers out at two.
I think John Cena just said, to heck with wrestling. Let's turn this into a fight.
John Cena looking to wear down Daniel Bryan. Cena realizes he needs to keep the pace slow. Ground Bryan, not allow him to get that momentum going. We all know what Bryan can do when he starts flying around the ring.
Daniel Bryan's one of the most exciting superstars I've ever seen in my life. He's one of the greatest roles I've ever seen in my life. And you're right, you better keep the flying goat down.
As I said earlier, Triple H, kind of referee, is going to let these guys go. That's what I like about it.
I agree with you, King. Matches like this should be sat in the ring, not by a referee.
Here comes the number one contender for the WWE title.
And the game's gonna let some fish fly here as well, too. That's all right.
You better believe it is.
This is what Cena had to be careful of.
Don't gloat, goat. Keep it up.
Oh, it's Cena. This is no low gear for Daniel Bryan, is it?
No, they're in.
But he who hesitates is lost.
He drives it like he stole it.
And this is what I was talking about. This is what Cena had to stay away from. Momentum starting to switch, starting to build for Bryan. He's starting to feel the feed off the WWE fans.
Daniel Bryan knows that this is his date with destiny.
And through all this, the lead up to tonight, Bryan's been confident.
Oh,
he believes he could beat Cena. Cena ducked underneath, and Cena with a shoulder tackle.
Whoa!
And John Cena on display.
Come on, John, you gotta do it.
Another shovel just to aim at the hairy ball.
He does not fear the beard. Oh!
Bryan trying to wrestle Cena to the ground. Cena rolling through. Nice takedown on Daniel Bryan as well.
Nice counter by John Cena.
And a nice counter by Bryan.
Here it comes. Five knuckle shuffle. Oh!
And it may be a matter of time. John Cena in position for the AA. And here he is, Daniel Bryan up on his shoulders. John Cena looking to put Daniel Bryan away. Still in this thing.
Right on the chin.
Daniel Bryan going way up top.
Is it enough to put the champ away? Over the leg by Daniel Bryan and a kick out of two. And a shiner begins to grow under the left eye of Cena.
Could have been that boot in the corner.
Well, that shot right before he was about to deliver that first you can't see me.
And that could become problematic if Cena's left eye closes.
Well, the one key model is under the eye. If it's above the eye, that's when you really start worrying. Because that's when you get where you can't see.
It's swelling fast, though.
Imagine Daniel Bryan after Cena beats The Rock at WrestleMania that Daniel Bryan takes the championship from him at SummerSlam.
Oh, what's his elbow? What's
it? Yeah, we questioned this earlier whether Bryan would target the elbow and he has.
Of course he will.
It's about the WWE title, doing anything you can to win the gold. Become the top dog around here.
Very few chances you get in your life to be world champion, WWE champion. Daniel Bryan knows that.
He may never get another opportunity.
Watching this match, I'm getting the impression that it would take an awful lot for Triple H to disqualify either one of these guys.
A wrestling match for an old-fashioned fight.
And I think the game is going to let him fight.
Daniel Bryan's really been working on left arm.
And I can see that strong toe hold.
What a great counter.
John Cena off the drop toe hold. Usually goes to the STF, but Daniel Bryan will kick his way out of this thing. And now Daniel Bryan going for the S lock.
Got him in his own hold.
What? No, it isn't. He's got Cena in his hold. Daniel Bryan has turned the tables on the champion.
Cena can lose his match in his very own hold.
Oh, my God.
Can you imagine that?
Unheard of.
Daniel Bryan with John Cena locked in with Cena's old hold. Will John Cena make it to the bottom rope here? Is Cena going to tap out? Championship on the line. Submission gives the title to Bryan.
You can't tell me Daniel Bryan wouldn't wait on this opportunity. He wants to tap John Cena out in his own hold.
Cena trying to somehow to drag Bryan to the bottom rope. Daniel Bryan bringing Cena back to the middle of the ring. John Cena off balance, one leg. What's Bryan doing here? Oh, man. What a suplex! Shoulders down! And Cena kicks out at two! Incredible.
And what a match! Oh, again!
German suplex by Daniel Bryan! Again, Cena stacked out and again! But Daniel Bryan still with the arm locks around the waist of Cena. Now Cena
Look at that strength!
And now Daniel Bryan!
Back that arm!
Back to the arm. Bryan's got it locked in. Is Cena going to tap? Cena going to tap out. Bryan going to win the WWE Championship here. Cena's got nowhere to go, middle of the ring. Cena looking at China.
He's
somehow maneuver his head.
Trying to get some of that pressure off. He's done it. Not all of it. Oh, no, it's getting locked back in again.
And again, Daniel Bryan with it locked back in. Cena doing a nice job trying to get his head up underneath there. John Cena powering out.
He's out.
Cena trying to fight out of this. And look at Daniel Bryan.
Cena just flailing away.
Daniel Bryan pugnacious.
He's on Cena like a spider monkey.
Daniel Bryan pugnacious. Cena's down to his knees. It's maybe only a matter of time before Daniel Bryan wins the championship here.
I don't think Cena can get out.
Triple H, perfect position. Will Cena tap out or will Cena pass out?
If Cena doesn't tap, he's going to be asleep soon.
Yeah, John Cena, desperate times here for the champion. WWE fans and Staples firmly behind Daniel Bryan. John Cena looking to use his strength to try to power out of this.
Strength of John Cena. That is incredible.
Yeah, but how do you loosen Daniel Bryan's grip the hips that way? And again, Daniel Bryan is still hanging on. John Cena has no way out of this.
Cena weakening.
Cena wants to break the hold. He just needs to grab the ropes.
Well, he breaks it there momentarily, but so much has been taken out of the champion. Cena's face is a mess. Mm. And look at this. DNA.
Got it.
Cena from out of nowhere. From out of the Bryan kicked out. Bryan kicked out. Looked almost desperate for Cena as he hoisted Bryan up into the AA, and Daniel Bryan still managed to kick out of Cena's finishing maneuver.
I know he liked the kid.
Watch this. I'm telling you, that's as good an AA as you're gonna see, but it didn't put Daniel Bryan away.
And he had it covered in the leg hook too, King.
And realizing that Bryan just kicked out of the AA, John Cena looking to pull out all the stops. Daniel Bryan right back on the attack. Cena went up high to make cost the champion. Cena continued to fight back, but Daniel Bryan keeps coming back and coming back and coming back. Whoa. Cena continues to thwart the attacks.
Daniel Bryan will not quit.
No, not at all.
I love it.
Daniel Bryan caught Cena.
Yeah, Cena's hanging on.
Oh my God.
Daniel Bryan knows how important this night is.
High
stakes.
This
doesn't end well.
High stakes, high risk, high above the ring at Staples. Superplex in the win.
And Daniel Bryan hangs on.
Daniel Bryan hanging on. Daniel Bryan didn't absorb the normal impact of the superplex.
Oh my gosh.
Daniel Bryan with John Cena out in the middle of the ring.
It's time to fear the beard.
We're about to go Eric Goat. And it might be for the WWE Championship.
Connecting. Is it Bryan's time? Is it his moment? Right here. Right now. Not yet. And Cena wisely rolls out of the ring to try to regather himself.
Watch this again. Flying headbutt. And it hits its mark. I thought Cena was finished.
What great presence John Cena has to roll out of the ring.
Uh-oh. Yeah, but
what's Daniel Bryan thinking here?
Daniel.
Incoming!
Oh. Cena knew it was coming. Cena lying and waiting. Bryan paid for it.
Do you think John Cena has changed Daniel Bryan's opinion? I mean, being not a wrestler, but an entertainer?
Cena gonna go up high one more time. John Cena paid for this last time. Will John Cena be able to connect now?
Oh my God!
That should do it.
John Cena covers Bryan, and Bryan again stays alive. Talk about guts.
Wow. What's the height that John Cena gets here? And as you said, he connects. How did that not finish off Daniel Bryan?
Did you notice Cena in the upper left-hand corner of your screen when that replay was playing? He was looking at Triple H holding up the two fingers, saying it was just two. It was just two, almost like he was begging for a three count. He thought he had Bryan there. What a feeling here tonight in Los Angeles.
What a show we've had tonight. And what a WWE championship we have right now.
It's anybody's ball game.
Uh-oh.
John Cena.
What is he thinking here?
With Daniel Bryan up high, but look at Bryan fighting back. This kid didn't go away.
Oh, he's just hammering into the side of John's neck and head. How much punishment can Cena take?
What is Bryan going to do here? What's he going to try to do here? This time it's Cena.
That strength. That's the strength we talked about all night.
Oh, man. Ow. Daniel Bryan landing right on his head. And now Cena the STF. And now the move that Bryan used earlier. Cena brings back now. Oh. He's got Bryan locked in. Will Bryan tap out? It's for the championship. It's for the gold. He's looking in the eyes of the referee, Triple H. Will Bryan tap out? Is he going to tap out? Cena's got it in. Bryan trying to drag himself to the ropes. For Daniel Bryan, the moment of truth.
He's rolling, trying to.
But Cena still got it locked in. Bryan didn't know where to go.
Still got it locked in.
And it's legal. You notice how Cena's forearms on the chin of Bryan. Bryan may be fading
here.
Yes,
he is.
Bryan has no leverage anywhere.
Daniel Bryan may be fading here.
Daniel Bryan has nowhere to go.
That leg is locked. He's on his back. He's in trouble.
Triple H is at the ready. If Bryan taps out here, let me face down Daniel Bryan. Daniel Bryan, reversal. The battle. Daniel Bryan, yes, lock. What's Cena going to do? Is he going to tap out?
He almost tapped.
All for the WWE Championship. Bryan found that he'd make Cena tap tonight. Will it happen?
Cena trying to eye those ropes, but you're a long way away, John.
Cena trying to do everything he can in his power to make it to the ropes, forces a break. Bryan's got a break. He's got a break by five, but he's disqualified. Three. He loses his opportunity. Smart move by Bryan. Man, Cena has been through a battle tonight.
Both these men have.
And look at Triple H.
I'm all right. I'm okay.
Questioning Cena and his elbow.
I think Triple H was calling for the doctor.
Yeah, I believe so too, but Cena waved it off, saying he was okay. Daniel Bryan. Daniel Bryan back and forth. Momentum again to Cena. Cena down in the corner. Daniel Bryan third time. Runs into a wicked clothesline.
What a freaking clothesline.
A wicked clothesline by Cena.
Daniel Bryan turned to 360.
Cena can cover him right now. I think Cena's got it. What a collision.
Watch his impact. Watch Cena. Watch Cena here.
Watch this clothesline.
Boom.
Almost knocked Daniel Bryan right out of his boots.
These two tremendous superstars have left it all in the ring tonight for the WWE Championship. This match is gonna come down to who's the toughest, to who has more left in the tank, to who has the will.
I think it's just gonna come down to whoever can hit the last big move on the other one.
And Cena with a strike of his own. What a match.
Kidding. What's this again? Both these guys thinking the same thing. Hitting those ropes, coming with everything they got.
Now it's Bryan starting to stir. Cena stirring as well. This is a crucial moment of this matchup, because the first man to his feet could gain momentum to put this away.
And look at the game looking down at these two warriors here. He's got to be thinking, is this ever going to end? Can one of these guys get the best of the other?
Both men leaning on each other, using each other's bodies and momentum to get back to their feet.
Come on! Come on!
Cena and Bryan.
Cena calling for the very best of Daniel Bryan. He's about to get it.
Bryan calling for the best of Cena.
They're firing each other up. You gotta kid me, this is great.
It's a new gear. Here comes Bryan. Bryan's taking it to Cena. They've come out of their seats at the Staples Center.
And here comes Cena.
Bryan up over the top. Cena caught him. Cena caught him. And he just muscles Bryan up.
Can he get that attitude adjustment? No.
Oh, the counter by Bryan.
Wow. Oh, man. Daniel Bryan somehow just planted John Cena face first.
I got goosebumps.
Talk about two warriors. What a championship match. What a SummerSlam.
What these two won't do for the WWE title.
It's that important.
It makes careers. The prestige that comes with it. Daniel Bryan's moment in time could be right here.
He's feeling it. He knows it.
And John Cena said it's over.
That's the strength of John Cena.
Daniel Bryan up on the shoulders. Going for the AA. Bryan pulls him over. Hooks the leg. Shoulders are down. He got him down too. Bryan misses wildly. And he caught him to the side of the head.
Congratulations,
Daniel Bryan. And the 26th annual SummerSlam indeed paid off. Lived up to the hype. An incredible moment.
Yes. This could be the year of the beard.
I am voices in my head.
Oh my God. Mr. Money in the Bank, Randy Orton, briefcase and contract in tow.
Randy Orton's about to cash in.
Is Randy Orton going to ruin Bryant's moment?
This isn't real.
You talk about a damper on a party. It's the damnedest SummerSlam I've ever seen.
You gotta be kidding me.
You can't help but feel bad for Daniel Bryan.
Daniel Bryan.
Well, you know what, guys? Look at it this way. Mr. McMahon just got his wish. He didn't want Cena to be champion, and he sure as hell didn't want Daniel Bryan to be champion.
But King, Triple H of all people.
He is awake. He wants something that Braun has.
I am more than a man. I am the thing that nightmares are made of.
The monster, Braun Strowman. The diabolical fiend, Bray Wyatt. For the Universal Championship. WWE SummerSlam. You'll never see it coming.
An absolutely unbelievable performance by Daniel Bryan, overcoming the odds and defeating John Cena to capture the WWE Championship, only to have it ripped away from him just moments later by the Viper Randy Orton due to the underhanded tactics of Triple H. Speaking of overcoming the odds, Brock Lesnar would need Lady Luck on his side at the 2017 SummerSlam. Lesnar had to defend his title against three of the biggest superstars in the WWE. Roman Reigns, Samoa Joe, and the monster Braun Strowman in a fatal four-way match.
The following contest is a fatal four-way match scheduled for one fall. And it is for the Universal Championship. Introducing the challengers. First, weighing in at 385 pounds, Braun Strowman. Next, from Huntington Beach, California, weighing in at 282 pounds, Samoa Joe. Next, from Pensacola, Florida, weighing in at 265 pounds, Roman Reigns. And from
ladies and gentlemen, my name is Paul Heyman. Tonight, fighting out of the Conqueror's Corner, the reigning, defending, undisputed Universal Champion, Brock Lesnar!
Ladies and gentlemen, there is over 1,000 pounds of WWE superstars in this fatal four-way match tonight. In the ring, no disqualification, no countouts.
I assure you, we are not on Skull Island. We are in Brooklyn, New York. Monsters are real. There are beasts, there are big dogs, and there are destroyers. This thing may flatten the entire city.
And there are 16,128 WWE fans packed into the Barclays Center tonight. Lesnar, Strowman, Joe, Reigns, fatal four-way for the Universal title. And here we go!
Here we go, guys!
Strowman goes right after Reigns, Joe right after Lesnar.
And the hostility between all four of these superstars is palpable. All four want to destroy one another. Look at Joe bringing the fight.
Oh, baby!
Suplex by Brock. Remember, Samoa Joe came within a whisper of winning the championship at Great Balls of Fire in a match against Lesnar. And Strowman off the steel post. And think about what Reigns and Strowman have been through over the past number of months.
Wait a minute.
Oh, he's caught. It's a call-out moment right here, guys.
You saw Lesnar's body language before the bell, like a caged animal waiting to be unleashed.
And we have been waiting for this for a long, long time.
You're talking about ways to lose for Brock Lesnar. Brock Lesnar knows nothing but winning. I mean, he went into the UFC and beat Randy Couture, an Olympic caliber grappler. You gotta love it.
Lesnar, German suplex. Brooklyn's now Suplex City.
And New York may have to add a sixth burn.
Oh, my goodness.
Brock Lesnar is incredible.
Is it too late to change my pick?
You sure you want to?
Good luck trying to suplex the Monster Among Men. And did you see the look in the eyes as they grew wide of Brock Lesnar? And Roman Reigns and Samoa Joe back into the ring.
Crossing flight path to take out prospective opponents. Look at this. All four of these juggernauts trying to flatten one another.
Clothesline from Lesnar. And now once again, Strowman and Lesnar square off.
These two behemoths are gonna lock horns.
Oh man, you can feel it in here. It is electric. Corey, I have waited a long time for these two men to lock horns.
There we go.
And these two big bulls are going at it. Strowman with a splash to Lesnar.
Did you see that?
And Strowman now driving Lesnar over the top rope. The beast is down. And a roar from Strowman.
What I'm talking about, guys, that's that destructive force in Braun Strowman.
Here comes Reigns.
He's going to send Strowman. He'll try to anyway, but Strowman just like that shoves the big dog away. Oh. And there's the quickness of Reigns as Strowman goes shoulder first into the post.
Strowman's going to need a whole lot of that.
Coquina
clutch on Brock Lesnar. Lesnar's in trouble outside the ring.
Samoa Joe won't win the title if he puts Lesnar to sleep out here, but he'll certainly eliminate the Beast through the barricade.
You gotta be kidding me.
Here comes Samoa Joe looking to capitalize on the carnage.
And out Joe brains onto the table.
Samoa Joe, that's your pick right there, Corey, right?
You're absolutely.
And now Strowman
oh, goes
over the table.
I said it all along. No one can touch Braun Strowman.
This could be catastrophic tonight.
God hope Strowman uses Saxton as a weapon.
And Strowman now. One can only imagine what the monster among men has in mind. And now look at Lesnar trying to pick up part of that wall, but again blasted by Strowman. That's the Universal Champion Lesnar who's in trouble. And look at how Strowman just with ease picked Lesnar up on his shoulder.
I don't think Brock Lesnar has ever been manhandled like Braun Strowman's doing right now.
And Lesnar through the table, a running power slam through the table.
I tell you guys, I've been in this business a long time and I've never seen a man like Braun Strowman ever. Wow.
I'm shocked.
Someone get FEMA on the phone. I think we're going to qualify after this disaster.
I mean,
my
Braun Strowman just drove Lesnar through the announce table with a running power slam.
I tell you guys,
oh, Roman Reigns, though.
If it's a night to make your career, this is it right here, SummerSlam 2017.
Look out from behind.
This is awesome.
And oh, my God. Wow. Jet flying through the ropes.
As was just made evidently clear. You need to have eyes in the back of your head.
But guys, let's put this in perspective. These are huge men, all of them near 300 pounds, and they're flying around out here like cruiserweights.
You said jumbo jet. That was like a C-130 right there, Cole.
Good call, but Lesnar trying to just crawl out of the wreckage.
Oh, no!
Oh, wow. The chair through Reigns and Joe. I mean, this is absolutely insane.
Joe caught the brunt of it, too, man. He caught the brunt of that chair right to the face.
Strowman might put Mayflower and Old Dominion out of business. He's just rearranging the entire world.
Brock has no idea where he is. Strowman again turns his attack to Lesnar, again with Lesnar on his shoulder. He is manhandling the beast.
Let's
and again, Lesnar driven through the table. Another running power slam.
Never seen anybody handle Brock Lesnar like this.
This is unfamiliar territory for Lesnar. It's gotta be. Brock Lesnar came into this match with a giant target painted on him.
All three
challengers are going right after the beast.
As well as Corey, a big chip on his shoulder.
Corey, I have covered Brock Lesnar's entire career here. Since the day he arrived on the scene, I have never, ever seen Brock Lesnar in this state manhandled this way by one human being.
Let me correct you, Cole. Brock Lesnar hasn't been manhandled. He's been monster handled.
Watch this. This was the first one. The running power slam by Strowman. And then as Brock somehow made his way out of the wreckage back to his feet, this happened.
There is no way on earth that a human being can survive what Lesnar just endured. We are about to truly find out what the Universal Champion is made of.
16,000 strong at Barclays Center on their feet. In
oh, no, no, no.
Of the monster on the man.
No, no. Don't
table.
Do this, Strowman.
The announce table standing. And Braun Strowman dumped into the champion.
He might have broken Lesnar's legs.
Paul Heyman is begging and pleading with Braun Strowman to stop. Brock Lesnar has been flattened at the hands of Strowman.
You might need the NYPD at this point. Strowman is unstoppable.
This is chaos, guys.
A half a dozen men trying to get that announce table off Brock Lesnar when one man picked it up off the ground and just planted it on Lesnar.
There are no rules, though.
Yeah, there's no countouts. There's no disqualifications.
Well, Strowman's just doing his job.
This is one of the most chaotic scenes I can remember. And now you see your officials down there calling for help. I believe they're calling for paramedics to make their way down to ringside.
You can't blame them. I mean, Brock Lesnar, an elite athlete, a freak of nature to be sure, but that announce table weighs hundreds of pounds. It was just unceremoniously dropped across the Universal Champion's body.
And Lesnar's hurt. Brock Lesnar is going to be strapped onto that body board as we take another look at what happened to Lesnar. Number one.
And again, I maintain that would have flattened any normal man.
Number two.
That would have put most normal men in the hospital.
And number three.
This will put a beast incarnate in the emergency room.
Yeah.
And that's where Brock Lesnar may be headed. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the champion.
That could be internal injuries. It could be anything. That table was pretty heavy coming down on Brock Lesnar.
And now the official make the decision has to be made. Does this match continue? I would assume it does as they cart the champion out of here.
You would think. I mean, we need a decision. We need to have a Universal Champion walk out of Barclays Center.
What's the rules here, guys? Do the match continue?
Well, the rules are this. First man to gain pinfall or submission wins the championship. And Strowman screaming at Lesnar. He's taking the champ, the beast, out of this match.
But Brock Lesnar has not submitted. He's being medically evacuated from ringside, but that doesn't count as a submission, does it?
It doesn't matter, Corey. He's been taken straight out of the equation. He's done. You know
no,
what
he's
this
not.
Means,
no,
guys?
Wait a minute. Brock may be done, but Strowman isn't.
You know what this means? This means we're going to have a new champion here tonight.
Oh, look at this.
Braun Strowman now with steps as a weapon. And the lethal Braun Strowman.
Unbelievable strength.
And now Reigns goes down.
If it's not laid nailed down to the floor, Strowman is using it as a weapon.
Guys, I've never, ever seen anything like this. I've never witnessed this.
Strowman threw those stairs across the ring, 20 feet like a toy.
He's taken out Lesnar. He turns his attention to Reigns. And think about the disdain that Strowman has for Roman Reigns. And remember, this match has to end in the ring. Strowman has Reigns back in the ring. Reigns back on the attack.
We know Reigns lives the situations with his back against the wall.
So now it becomes, at this juncture, a triple threat match because Lesnar's been hauled out of the arena.
Doesn't get any more adversarial for Roman.
Reigns now with the steps.
Oh,
and Braun Strowman, that hesitation by Reigns may have cost him, although he caught Strowman in the temple.
The point of the stairs. Right
and
in the monster.
Steps again to Strowman. And Strowman now, but still on his feet. This is a third shot with the steps, finally sending Strowman outside the ring. Oh. And now the steps.
First time we've seen Strowman
look out
down.
From behind.
Joe from behind, Joe from behind. Rolling up Reigns. Will Joe do it? Oh, Joe almost stole it.
Great situational awareness by Samoa Joe. That's veteran experience.
Inverted atomic drop into the boot to the face. There's the running senton by Joe. Cover. Will he become Universal Champion tonight? Almost had it.
Joe buying his time. Almost got a victory right there. Using his noodle right now to get a victory.
You know, Samoa Joe has fared very well against Roman Reigns. One-on-one competitions in the past.
Now, Samoa Joe, while Braun Strowman was beating the heck out of Brock Lesnar, I guess was able to regain some of his composure, get back into things here. And now he turns the attention to Reigns, went for the Uranagi, and Roman Reigns able to counter. And now Reigns with a solid drop. Cover for the Universal Championship, kick out by Joe.
That's what makes Roman Reigns so special. You could just beat on him and beat on him, but he's gonna be there in the end. You're gonna have to put him to sleep if you wanna beat him.
But this is critical right now, guys, for Joe and Reigns. They have to try to win this match while Braun Strowman is still outside the ring.
Exactly, you're not gonna get any better of a situation.
Can one of these men capitalize? Will it be Roman Reigns? Roman locked and loaded. Reigns went for the Superman punch, got a kick to the midsection. Joe going for the Coquina clutch.
It's in.
The clutch that almost took out Lesnar last month.
Samoa Joe grasping for his own bicep, looking to finish the submission.
But Strowman back in.
No, you got to be kidding
double
me.
Double chokeslam by Strowman. Cover for the Universal Championship, and Reigns got the shoulder up.
Oh, my goodness.
Wow.
You can see the effects from the beating with the steel chairs that Braun Strowman sustained, but still, the monster among men is the last man in control.
Yeah, I thought the first of the steel step shots actually caught Braun Strowman in the ear area, and that's where, of course, the battle scar is forming.
the strength of Braun Strowman, man. I mean, a double choke slam, Samoa Joe and Roman Reigns. You got to be kidding me.
Which one of these men will survive? Oh. Who will become Universal Champion tonight at SummerSlam?
All three of these gladiators have given it everything in their beings just for the right to leave New York as the Universal Champion.
Oh, wait, wait a minute. Here comes the champ. Lesnar's back at his feet. Officials pleading with Lesnar, but he's marching back to the ring to defend his title.
The true warrior right there, Cole.
And he's going face to face with Strowman. There's the takedown by Lesnar. And there's the Beast. The Beast unleashing on Braun Strowman.
Hammer fists raining down on the monster. Where is Lesnar getting this?
And a clubbing blow to the side of the face. And now Reigns. And he's going to suffer a German suplex. And now Joe. Another German.
Champion's back against the wall. That's when you see what he's made of right there. That's Brock Lesnar.
And now Braun Strowman back in from behind. I can't believe Lesnar's even out here. And Braun Strowman looking to continue to punish Lesnar.
No way.
Oh.
No way. Strowman just too big.
Yeah, elbow planted right on the bridge of the nose.
He's trying to suplex a sequoia tree.
Uh-oh. Oh, look at this.
Lesnar's looking for the Kimura.
Yeah, trying the Kimura on Braun Strowman.
Braun walked right into it also.
And now Braun Strowman, what's he going to do? Brock Lesnar trying to get Strowman to tap out here.
The more Strowman trying to get out of, the more pressure.
Superman
punch.
Oh,
wow.
Reigns saving the championship match for himself. And another Superman punch to Lesnar.
Joe joining the fracas.
And a third. Could Roman Reigns be closing down the championship? Brock Lesnar's stunned. The Beast not sure where he's at. Roman Reigns stalking, ready for the spear.
That war cry, that could be it.
For the Universal Championship. And Lesnar just got his shoulder up.
Wow.
We've seen in the past, the spear could be the Achilles heel for the Beast incarnate, but was not the case tonight.
Reigns cannot believe that Lesnar kicked out.
Normally Roman lands that big spear after that war cry. It's all over with, but that's the man, that's the heart, that's the champion of Brock Lesnar.
Guys, what type of credit can you give the champ tonight? As you said, Book, I mean, Lesnar's been through everything and he's still in here defending his title. Is Reigns gonna try it again? Brock Lesnar slowly trying to make it to his feet. And now Samoa Joe, Coquina clutch from behind. Is Reigns gonna tap? If Reigns taps, Joe's the champion. Oh, oh, oh. Drop kick. Is there anything he can't do?
The Tyrannosaurus drop kick from Braun Strowman.
Now Strowman with a running power slam again. Cover, will he become Universal Champion at SummerSlam?
You feel that earth shake on that.
Lesnar pulled out the referee, and again, no disqualification here tonight.
That's situational awareness from the champion protecting his title.
I think Strowman had Joe pinned.
And I don't think Brock Lesnar's 100%. I'm sorry, after what his body withstood.
You know something, Corey? I don't think any of these men right now are
Superman
100%.
Punch again.
I agree with you, Booker. All four of these superstars battered. Bruised.
There's a war.
And now Reigns. Superman punches Strowman.
Perfect position.
Cover for the title. Will it be Reigns? No, Strowman.
Holy cow. The power of Strowman.
Wow.
Just stood Roman Reigns upright.
Roman can't believe it. Roman Reigns, though, never say die. Dig down deep. One more opportunity.
Run to the well. One more time. Try to deliver that big shot.
And now Strowman looking to put away Roman Reigns with a running power slam. Cover on Reigns, and it's Lesnar saving his title.
It's not often you've ever seen Brock Lesnar in anything resembling a desperate situation.
Not like
but
this.
Right now, the Beast looks vulnerable.
I mean, the loot of the championship is out of Brock's hands if he's not in the ring. Perfect position. Get in there. Save the championship. That's what Brock is doing.
And Corey, you can talk about what happened with Goldberg last year and earlier this year with Lesnar, but that was more of a surprise. It happened so quickly to Brock. He got caught by sudden impact. Tonight has been just a physical beatdown by Strowman.
Yet the Beast incarnate keeps crawling forward. with whatever's left in his being. Apparently, Strowman's intent on removing.
And now look at Brock,
no way.
Power of Lesnar.
No.
But for the F5, Strowman though able to land back on his feet. Now he has Lesnar in his hands again. Going for yet another running power slam. Spear by Roman Reigns. Everyone down.
Reigns might have exhausted his last bit of energy to deliver the spear.
Brock Lesnar got out of harm's way there just a little bit.
But Brock Lesnar can actually thank Roman Reigns for the assist.
Indeed. Who's the worst for wear right there, guys?
And watch the spear by Reigns.
Oh, man.
Lesnar's, well, was back to his feet, back down to one knee. Reigns trying to make it back to his feet as well. Both these warriors showing you what they've been through tonight.
Uh-oh.
Over the F5 on Reigns. Samoa Joe from behind. Joe sends Reigns out of the ring. Now Samoa Joe turns his attention to the champion again, the Totino Clutch.
We've seen Brock Lesnar taken down by this submission once before, almost submitted in the past. Samoa Joe could be inching closer to the Universal title.
It was at Great Balls of Fire last month. We thought Brock was going to tap. Something happened as tonight. He picked Joe clean. And Brock with the F5 to Samoa Joe.
History repeats itself.
Into the cover. Hook of the leg.
That's it.
Roman Reigns saving the matchup for himself. Absolutely incredible.
This goes to show you how a fatal four-way completely changes the complexion of a matchup. That exact scenario occurred in a singles match and Lesnar defeated Samoa Joe. Here, the beatdown just continues.
Look at Brock. Brock is just stumbling, trying to get to his feet.
Trying to find his bearings right now, Cole.
Roman Reigns, another Superman punch. Universal Champion stumbles, doesn't go down, uses the ropes to stay up. Roman Reigns, locked and loaded again. Another Superman punch. Shades of WrestleMania a few years ago, but Brock Lesnar back to his feet.
Lesnar's weak in his knees. Lesnar might be out on his feet.
He is out
Roman
on his
Reigns,
feet.
Roman Reigns, a third time. Down goes the champion, and now Reigns is closing in. This is his moment. Can it be here at SummerSlam?
I tell you, if Roman Reigns can just land one more big shot, we may have a new champion here tonight, guys.
It may be the spear. That's what he's setting up for. Looking to take out the beast. Looking to slay Lesnar tonight. Roman, Brock picked him out of the air. Brock picked Roman, F5.
How?
Cover. Lesnar retains.
Wow.
Here is your winner and still the Universal Champion, Brock Lesnar.
Brock Lesnar retains the Universal title. The reign of the beast continues in one of the most physical matches I've ever witnessed.
I'm not a believer in it generally, but tonight, Lady Luck was on the Beast Incarnate's side.
Yeah, as well as a lot of heart from the champion, Corey.
The Beast was able to defy the odds and come away with a successful defense of the Universal Championship at SummerSlam 2017. For over 30 years, the hottest party of the summer has never disappointed and always brings the heat. SummerSlam has been home to heroes.
Ronda Rousey's done it! Ronda Rousey's the Raw Women's Champion!
Legends.
For the love of God, the elbow! My God, I don't believe what I just saw!
Rising stars.
We've got a new Universal Champion!
And the iconic moments that will live on in history.